He's got the 50. He cuts back. 10, 5, touchdown, Jonas Severson.
Rains back to pass.
Rainbow down the near side. He's got a man. Your touchdown, Wildcats!
Little pitch out. Severson
cuts it back up in there. He is in. Touchdown, Wildcats, Jonas Severson. It is game day. Good evening, everybody, and welcome. It's Division II, Level 3, WIAA football. The did West De Pere Phantoms have traveled to town to take on your River Falls Wildcats? Good evening, everybody, and welcome. I'm Kevin Westhouse, joined by my great partners, Jeff Johnson and Nate Sherman. Welcome, guys. How are you guys tonight?
Great to be here. It's been 34 years since we've been in Level 3, Kevin.
So. 34 years. 1988 was the last time River Falls was in Level 3 football. Tonight, here in 2022, it's a glorious night for football. It's 42 degrees. There's nary a breeze. The atmosphere is electric. Boy, I don't know about you guys. I'm looking forward to it.
Absolutely, and I'm sure the kids are too. They know they've cemented their names in the history books of River Falls High School, and they're hoping to take one more step tonight.
Yes, West De Pere. I mean, they come across the state. They travel 4 hours. They're number 3 seed. Wildcats, 1 seed. I think you can throw that out the window. It's going to be a fist fight tonight.
Absolutely. I think one thing I've never seen before, about 6 o'clock tonight, the student section was jam-packed full, so you know it's a big game.
Yeah, there's not many empty seats in the house. I know time is running down here before the game time. I'm going to run down quick and get a word in with head coach Ryan Scherz. Then I'll come back and join you guys back upstairs.
All right.
Sounds good.
Looking forward to a great game here.
Thanks, Kevin.
Yep.
Thank you.
All right, I'm going to head downstairs. See you courtside, field side.
All right, sounds good. While we're waiting for Kevin to start his interview with head coach Ryan Scherz, Wildcats coming into tonight's game with a record of 10-1, the Big Rivers Conference champions. Last week, if you tuned in, a 36-21 come-from-behind win over the Marshfield Tigers right here at David Smith Stadium. First time, Nate, all season that the Wildcats trailed by more than 2 scores.
Yeah, I think speaking for all of us, we were a little uneasy up here in the booth. But you know, it's been a signature of the Cats this year that they've been down and been able to mount good drives and come back. But being down two scores for the first time had us a little bit on the on our heels, but boy, they sure showed us what they were made of.
Yep, several big plays in the second half. They scored immediately after they went down nine, and from there on, it was a flurry of scores for the Wildcats as they ended the game on a 24-0 run to come out with a 36-21 victory over the Marshfield Tigers. Jacob Range last week, Nate, 6-11, 102 yards and 2 touchdowns throwing. He also had 11 carries for 66 yards, probably Jacob's best game of the season.
Yeah, I think so. You know, somebody might look at that and say 6-11, that's not great, but the fact that he didn't throw it to the other team, that he tucked it under and ran and made good decisions and found guys in clutch moments.
Jacob's been very solid the last 4 or 5 games of the season. As Jonah Severson goes, the Wildcats go generally too. Jonah, another big game, 31 carries, 172 yards, 3 touchdowns, no fumbles, just played an all-around great game, as he has several times this season.
Yeah, Jonah's tough, man, and we'll rely on him tonight. He's going to get his carries, and it'll be a big challenge. Last weekend, West Appear did not allow much for rushing yards against New Richmond, and, of course, they've got a fantastic back in Trandall, so we'll see. It should be a battle tonight.
Should be. Let's talk about the opposition tonight. The West DePere Phantoms finished second place to Bayport in the Fox River Classic North Conference. West DePere.
Now let's give one sound check if you could give me a thumbs up. All right.
All right, Kevin, getting ready to interview Coach Ryan Schurz. West DePere, like we mentioned earlier, 21-6 victory at New Richmond last week. Another Big Rivers Conference team. Solid game again by the Phantoms. They're led by their quarterback, Duke Scholwald, threw for 200 yards last week, and their running back, Najee Mitchell, who had 23 carries for 167 yards, 2 touchdowns. He's a fast one.
Yeah, he is. They say he runs a 4.37, which is lightning fast. He's a recruit for UMD,
Ryan Schurz.
We'll turn it over here.
Coach, you've already cemented yourself and this team into school history, being the second team to make it to level 3 in school history. How do you keep your team focused in a week like this?
Well, we're not done playing. So I think, you know, they don't want to be done. We love our time together. We want to keep playing. We want another week.
Are there any distractions this week, or is all football all the time?
I mean, they go to school and stuff like that. End of the term, but they did a nice job. They're ready to go.
Your offensive coaching staff, defensive coaching staff, were there any extra late nights this week preparing for tonight's game against Westwood?
They're a really good team. We do a, you know, both sides of the ball do a great job preparing. We know what kind of effort it's going to take, and I know that we're going to give them everything we got.
This is week, like penalties, ball control. I mean, any focuses, or is it just what you're going through?
Just trying to be the best version of this team. This is the 12th game. You know that, we'll be all right.
You're a young coach. You've done quite a job here in the last couple of years for the Wildcats. Any pride out of that? How do you feel?
We got great kids. We got great people. I'm glad that we can make people excited.
This is a special moment in school history. It's a special moment for you as a head coach. But we're not even aware of yet. Let's get it on against number 3 ranked DePere. Head coach Ryan Schurz, good luck tonight, coach. Let's take this right back upstairs to Johnson and
All right, thank you, Kevin. Sorry, our apologies for some of the audio difficulties we had there. Kevin, probably a little bit farther away from our base here than he normally is, but I think everybody should have gotten the gist of it. Business as usual, Nate. That's the message I took out of that.
Yeah, if you missed that, what you should know is that Coach Schurz is one humble human being. He is not going to take any of the credit away from the kids and the job that they've done this year. I know that he said that the coaching staff has put their time in like they always do, and I have no doubt that they've prepared their kids as well as possible for the game. All that's left is to play it and see what happens.
Absolutely. Yeah, we started talking about West DePere. Like we mentioned, outstanding quarterback Duke Scholwald. He's threw for 200 yards last week. He's had a 300-yard game this season as well. Unlike the Marshfield Tigers, he likes to spread it around. There's several receivers for West Appear that got in on the action last week. Landon Nordgaard had 5 catches for 92 yards. Ben Lemerand, Ryder Lesage, and he'll throw it to his back, Najee Mitchell as well, out of the backfield. So you will see a host of Phantoms touching the football tonight, which obviously puts a lot of stress on the defense.
Yeah, Schovald's good, and their coach runs a good offense. They will run a lot of 3 up to 5 wide receiver sets. They will often have the outside receiver breaking in and the inside receiver breaking out, running crossing patterns and throw to the opposite of where the guy started. And Schovald, unlike the quarterback last week, he seems to be the kind of guy who likes to buy time in the backfield to throw, not necessarily to run. It's not that he won't run it, but unlike last week from Marshfield, Schovald wants to put it in the air.
Yes, he does, and he does a nice job. Probably the best throwing quarterback, I'd say by far, I think, that we've seen this season. No offense to anybody that we've played so far, but it's a good quality, solid football team, a very good defense. As well, we'll point out some of their top defensive players as we go through the evening, but just watching them on film, they're fast on defense as well. They move to the ball very quickly, and it's going to take a supreme effort by the Wildcats to come out victorious tonight.
Yeah, I watched some film too, Jeff, and I thought the same thing. The first thing I saw was great team speed. They play a base 4-3 defense, so 4 down linemen, 3 backers, and a 2 deep defensive back set. And they do mix it up a little bit with an occasional blitz or a stunt on the line. Even a zone blitz where a defensive lineman will drop back into the linebacker position while the linebacker blitzes. But they don't do a ton of that. I think they just rely on their athleticism and aggressiveness and the speed that they have. They're not overly big, Jeff.
No.
But they're big enough and as big as we are. And speaking back to New Richmond, New Richmond could not get around the corner on these guys. They just tracked him down, and any yards they did get was between the tackles.
Yeah, they pursue the ball very well. One player that jumped off the film to me was number 27, Andrew Baumgart, defensive lineman. Very fast. They had a hard time blocking him. It seemed like he was making tackle after tackle. First-team all-conference player for the Phantoms. So he's one of many players that we'll need to keep an eye on tonight.
Yeah, he made a mess of it in the backfield a number of times. Yes. And you know, a lot of times when you think of defensive linemen stunting, basically crisscrossing, trading positions, you think of attempting to get a sack. But there's some run stunts, too. And, boy, blocking schemes can get messed up in that regard as well.
Yep, absolutely. Kevin, welcome back.
Hey, thanks. Coach Scherz, he's cooler than the other side of the pillow tonight. He's not, you know, he's just being Ryan Scherz, right? He understands the gravity of the game, but he also, I think, he's probably a really good coach to coach under, where he doesn't get too excited and doesn't get too down. He just is between a 4 and a 6 and is letting his team do what they do, I believe.
Yeah, I watched the team come off the bus and walk into the stadium tonight, and they look like they're on a business trip, really, kind of like they did last week, where not too up, not too down. They know why they're here, and I think we're going to get a real good effort out of the Wildcats tonight.
I believe you're right.
We can talk about some of the other games that are going on tonight that we'll be keeping an eye on in the WIAA Division II football playoffs. You'll see the bracket up on your screen there. Obviously, we're here at David Smith Stadium, River Falls versus West Appear. The winner of this game will take on the winner of the game that we'll be tracking as well between Homestead. They're out of Mequon, Wisconsin, north of Milwaukee. They'll take on Kaukauna.
The Galloping Ghosts over there in Kaukauna.
Yes, that game is at Homestead. So that's a 5 seed versus a 6 seed. Again, and the winner of that game will face the winner of this game at a neutral site. In level 4, so all level 4 games are on a neutral field.
There we go.
And the other side of the bracket is a couple of games there as well. Burlington will be traveling to Brookfield Central to take on the Lancers, and Sun Prairie East will be traveling to Kettle Moraine to take on the Lasers in Kettle Moraine. So we'll keep an eye on all 3 of those games for you on our ticker at the bottom of your screen.
Yeah. Braden was going to get that going a little bit faster, but he said, no, it's good enough right where it is. Doing a lot of things. Hey, welcome aboard, everybody. Just a little housekeeping. Remember, keep the comments clean and neat and tidy. Remember, what you type on the internet will never go away. We will find you. So just keep it polite, keep it fun. Don't get too nasty. Hey, Will Johnson, you weren't the first person on tonight. I can't believe it. You're on early. So, Will, welcome aboard. John, Michelle, Dunham, welcome aboard. Luke, welcome everybody. We've got some room for you in the garage here yet. Wildcats come out of the locker room. They're going to be getting ready to go here shortly. 3:40 on the clock, getting ready for kickoff. I'm all excited. Folks at home, get to the edge of your seats. Got our new on-field camera. We're adding every week, right? So John Fry down there fieldside for you. Going to try to bring this right into your living room. Gavin Cole's going to lead his team out. They're all jacked up on a case of level 3. All right.
I like the on-field camera, Kevin.
Look at that. We never quit, do we?
No.
Every week.
It's getting better and better every week.
We got that. And let's go. Here come the Wildcats. Oh, baby. What a great week. Wildcats in the blue pant, the blue top, and the white bonnet tonight. The West Appear Phantoms in the white shirt, white pant, and the, what color is their hat? Is that like a dark
black,
blue?
Black? Maybe. I think that's black.
They're ready to go. So, yeah, white against dark blue. Let's just keep it that, at that.
Speaking of ready to go, the Wildcat parent section is definitely ready to go tonight.
They're ready to go, tuned up. There's not many empty seats in the house tonight. A few on the far side, but we're 97% full tonight here at David Smith Stadium at Raymer Field on the campus of the University of Wisconsin, River Falls. Kevin Westhouse, Jeff Johnson, Nate Sherman, the artist Rob Derry, Braden Engstrom, and John Fry with a field camera tonight. We get added to our crew. Welcome aboard, everybody. We're excited to be bringing you Division II, Level 3 WIAA football. There's 8 left in the state. Going to get down to 4 after tonight. Boy, that's a nice look.
It is. Never seen it from that angle before. That's pretty cool.
Braden's feeling like old home week, that camera guy. Getting set up for our national anthem. I think our River Falls High School pep band is going to bring that to you. Sarah Jenkins, we should probably thank her as well. We got a second here. Sarah Jenkins is our game sponsor tonight. Sarah Jenkins, property executive. She's paid the $250 to the WIAA, so we're able to bring you this game tonight. Thank you, Sarah Jenkins, sarahjenkins.com. I saw some of her weekly videos she does on real estate updates. They're really good. Go to sarahjenkins.com and check it out. Thank you, Sarah Jenkins, for sponsoring tonight's game. Jared Bahacek. Bahacek's cheering from Sedona, Arizona. Jared, a 1989 Wildcat, I believe. Wasn't he a quarterback? I think he told me.
Did you say Sarah's watching from Miami? Did you point that?
Yeah. I didn't. Sarah Jenkins watching from Miami. I just saw that. Yeah. So,
a little warmer than where we're at right now, I would say.
Man, those early snowbirds from up north are already going south. Got my brother-in-law watching from Sarasota. He's reading MRIs, and he happens to have a game on one of his monitors. So,
Mike Dunham.
Dr. Phelan.
My brother-in-law, Mike Dunham, watching from Tucson, Arizona.
Here we go.
Welcome, Mike.
So I did check last week. We had 25 states represented last week.
Mm-hmm. So, let's see if we can top that.
Smith Stadium here on field for tonight's WIAA Level 3 playoff game between the West Appear Phantoms and your River Falls Wildcats.
Jared Pachek says 1995.
River Falls must appear in the WIAA require good sportsmanship at education-based sporting events. Attendance at interscholastic activities is a privilege with the expectation to exhibit positive and respectful behavior. For the enjoyment and respect of all in attendance, your cooperation in demonstrating the high ideals of sportsmanship is expected and greatly appreciated. Please be reminded that state law prohibits the use of tobacco products in an area used by public schools. This includes the parking lot. We also ask for the assistance of parents to monitor your children at tonight's event. And now to honor America and those defending our freedom, we ask those who are able to stand, remove your hats, place your hand over your heart for the playing of our national anthem.
National anthem.
Let's honor America. Well, good evening again, everybody, and welcome to Level 3, Division 2 WIAA football from the campus of the University of Wisconsin, River Falls. It is football time here tonight. I'm Kevin Westhouse, joined by Jeff Johnson, Nate Sherman, Rob Derry, and Braden Engstrom. Mr. John Fry on the field camera. Welcome aboard, everybody. Boy, what a great night for football. Your starting lineups. First for West Appear, that's black. We've been reminded their colors are black, white, and orange. Thank you.
And now the starting defense for the River Falls Wildcats.
Starting defense for the River Falls Wildcats.
Number 6, defensive lineman Cade Mashevsky.
The muscle, Cade Mashevsky.
Number 7, linebacker Brody Rudolph.
Brody Rudolph.
Number 10, defensive back Preston Johnson.
Preston Johnson.
Number 13, defensive back, Bryce Babbitt.
Bryce Babbitt.
Number 22, defensive back, Wyatt Bell.
The dinger, Wyatt Bell. Hope to call him a few times tonight.
Back, Jacob Gilbertson.
Jacob Gilbertson.
Number 29, linebacker, Gavin Cole.
Gavin Cole.
Number 53, defensive lineman, Reese Yonke.
Reese Yonke.
Number 54, defensive lineman Lucas Johnson.
Lucas Johnson.
Number 68, defensive lineman Ben Esterby.
Ben Esterby.
Number 82, linebacker Zach Peterson.
Zach Peterson, all in the blue shoes.
And the rest of the Wildcats under the direction of head coach Ryan Scherz.
And the rest of the Wildcats under the direction of head coach Ryan Scherz. Well, it's raining down in, what is that called? Sun Prairie.
The Kettle Marines.
Raining cats and dogs are not here. Beautiful night for football in River Falls, Wisconsin. The rain is held off. We're in a drought. It ain't going to rain. Let's go. Pep band is tuned in. Wow. Welcome aboard, everybody. The garage is going to be full tonight. Everybody that came over to watch the game, she's going to be tight. We're definitely move your feet, lose your seat zone here. Can't guarantee your seat when you get up and go to the bathroom tonight. It's jam-packed, folks. Wall to wall, shoulder to shoulder. Everybody's tuned in to watch some good high school football. 8 teams left here in the state of Wisconsin in Division II. Looking to whittle that down to 4. Pep band's going, cheerleaders. Student section. So each class had a different color to wear. So to get the white, the yellow, the blue. Good work, student section from River Falls. All right, Wildcats are going to kick off. They're going from our right to left as you look at your screen at home. Back deep for the West Appear fandom. So I'm going to try to get a number. I'll take some help on that if you can see it.
Number 23, Thomas Welder, is on the near side.
Mm-hmm.
And not sure about the far side.
Starts with an 8.
Maybe 82, maybe Ben Lemerand.
It's either Lemerand or Gordon Jr. It's Walder, it's 82. Gordon Jr. over there. Kick is away. Fielded on the near side.
It's Walder.
Walder fakes the reverse, takes it to the far side. Now, nice open field tackle, trip down.
And we have a flag.
And the flag, flag on the play.
Bryce Bevan with the tackle.
But a flag on the play early. Let's see, they're conferring. See if we have a block in the back on the return team. Yep. Typically what we see there.
It is on the Phantoms holding, legal block.
Holding, that'll push them back a little bit there.
You know, that flag would have negated any run they did have, but that was a really important tackle by Bryce Bevans. They had an alley to run in there.
Let's talk about the starting defense. Outside linebacker, Cade Mischewski, Lucan Johnson, and Ben Esterby is your linebacker core tonight. Zach Peterson, Gavin Cole, Reese Yonke, and Brody Rudolph. Here we go. Duke Schovold, shotgun formation. Hand it off, give it to Najee Mitchell. Pushes the pile forward for the ball's on the ground. Wildcats think they have it.
And
they do. Early fumble, Wildcats recover on the 26. High fives all the way in. I don't know if we got a replay on that. I don't think we did on that one. Boy, the nice 11-yard run. They put it on the carpet. Wildcats recover. Wow. Big play. We talk about these types of games, turnovers and mistakes, right?
Preston Johnson with the fumble recovery.
Preston Johnson, the sophomore, number 10, does his job right away. You need one of those guys to step up like a Preston Johnson. He's been there all year and already makes a big play in the first play of the game. First and 10, Wildcats. Wow, turn my sheets over here. Oh, baby. Give it up the middle. Jonas Severson pushes the pile forward for four. It'll be second and six.
So one thing I noticed about West Kapir when they were lining up on the defensive side of the ball, against a double tight set, they would bring an outside linebacker up and turn their 4-3 into a more of a 5-2 look. They did that there on the opening, but we had some success running between the tackles with Severson.
Brendan's watching from the Virgin Islands. Second and six. Jacob Range is going to keep it. He's got to have a tough yard there. It's going to be third and long, third and five from the 22. Definitely four down territory here for the Wildcats. Jacob Range will make his way over to the sidelines to coaches to try to get a play. They'll shuttle it in. It'll be third and five, long five.
Watching that last play for West Appear, Reese Yonke did a really good job stripping the ball from the ball carrier, and then Preston Johnson fell on top of the ball, and Wildcats with great field position, but we need to capitalize right here.
Right here.
Wyatt Bell into the game for the Cats.
Second down, third down, and a long five. You could even call it six. Range under center. Man in motion. Pitch it out to the far side. Severson gets met in the backfield. He's going to lose three, and the ball's on the ground. I think West Appear may have recovered. Let's see. They're going to say he's down.
Referee said he's down.
But it'll be fourth and eight. Fourth and eight.
Obviously a position of the field here, Kevin, where they're going to clearly go for it. Much too far for a field goal.
Fourth down and eight. Wildcats going to go for it. They've been real sick. They're going to be a timeout on the field. They'll timeout River Falls. That'll be their first timeout of the game. And it might give us one chance to go thank our main sponsor, First National Bank of River Falls.
First National Bank of River Falls is a proud sponsor of River Falls High School. We've been sponsoring River Falls High School athletics for over 50 years. We're proud to support area students, student athletes, and educators within our schools. Together, we're building a better community, one child at a time.
Thank you. Thank you, First National Bank of River Falls. They're over there up on the hill in Prescott. They're downtown River Falls, and they're on the campus of the University of Wisconsin, River Falls. They sponsor everything Wildcat Sport right here on the River Falls Sports Broadcasting Network. Big play here to start this game. Wildcats get the early turnover, but they got a fourth and eight here, and they're going to go for it from the Phantom 25-yard line. Jacob Range. Pistol formation, flanked on the right side. Fake handoff, back to pass, looking. Got a man corner. Caught, is he in? Oh, they say incomplete out on the far side. It was gathered over there. Is that Jordan Karras?
It was Karras. He had a couple of steps on it. Looks like he juggled it.
Just juggled the ball. Oh, boy, that would have been a first and goal at the five. He juggled the ball. Referee right there says incomplete.
Take a look at it again.
Take a look at that again. Maybe get a better look at that with Rob Derry zooming in on that over there. We're going to get a better look here than I saw with the naked eye. Nice route. Had a man. Just lofted it in there. Ooh.
That's close. He only has to have 1 foot in, but apparently he didn't. Ref was right there.
Turn it over on downs. First and 10 now for West DePere. I'll hand it off. Najee Mitchell runs it up in there for three or four. It'll be second down and six.
Yeah, Mitchell's speed just in person really kind of jumps off the page, Nate. You can tell he's got a different level of speed than what we've seen this season.
Yeah, he's not a huge guy. In fact, he's pretty short, but he's maybe 180, and he runs hard. He hits the hole with a lot of speed, no doubt.
5'10", 181 is Najee Mitchell for the Phantoms from West DePere. Second down and six. Schovold, fake pass, handed off. Nice tackle in the backfield. Is that Gavin Cole there that got
wrapped
up?
Yes, it is. Gavin Cole with the tackle. I think Mitchell had 160 yards rushing against New Richmond last week, and, you know, he got his 6 or 7 yards between the tackles, but he was really difficult to tackle when he got outside.
Yeah, when he gets into the edge or that second level, which he got to a few times last week as well, gets past that defensive line, he is really, really difficult to bring down.
Duke Schovold with a good arm for West DePere. Let's see if he uses it here. It's an empty backfield. Three receivers here on the near side, couple up top. Schovold back to pass, looking, crossing route. That came in hot, and it just off the hands of receiver Ryder LeSage.
Ryder LeSage, the leading receiver, first-team all-conference player for the Phantoms. Like you said, it came in hot, it was incomplete, and it's fourth down.
Threw that Brett Favre dart from 10 feet. Jugs Gun had that one at 82. Let's take a look at that one more time. He had him over the middle. A pretty firm pass. It's going to be a tough catch. Sits down right in the open field and just in and out of the hands of LeSage. Punt time now for West DePere. Boy, defense is showing up just as we predicted in the beginning. Try to draw him off sides. No sail. The punt is away. It's a good, hot, spiraling kick. Great hang time. Caught back on the 25. Gets it to the outside. The dinger, Wyatt Bell. Now he has the edge. 25-30. Trying to find a little more edge. Gets it up to the 35-yard line. Wyatt Bell on a very nice return.
Really nice open field tackle that time by Nathan Held for the Phantoms. Good field position again.
Well, thanks, Sean. Sean's got a nice compliment to the broadcast crew. We try. This is all voluntary too, Sean, but I'm telling you, we never rest. Like what we're doing this week, we're going to do something better next week. That's our goal. All right, first and 10 now for the Wildcats. Defensive struggle thus far. Wildcats got an early turnover, one unable to capitalize, and now they have the ball on their own 35-yard line. Let's see. I don't think we're going to see anything fancy. It's been pretty much Jonas Severson's show all season. They're going to give it to him again right here. Gets it in behind the bags. He moves it forward for three. It'll be second and seven.
Yeah, yards are going to become much harder to come by for Jonah tonight. Very solid defense for the Phantoms. And big, solid front line. Lots of big kids there, and they got a lot of speed in the secondary.
Second down and seven. Wildcats have had a lot of success running the ball this year, but today these defenses are both very, very stingy. So the yards, like you said, Jeff, are going to be hard to come by tonight.
Double tight end look for the Wildcats right now. Johnson and Olsen in the game.
Hand off again to Severson. Moves it right up through the two hole. He gets about a yard. It'll be third and five.
I think pretty conservative approach so far for the Wildcats, which I think is warranted.
Severson
early in the game.
Severson a little dinged up on the play. He's going to try to make his way to the sidelines. A little hitch in the giddy up. I think he'll be okay. But
Charlie Lesh enters the game, number 32.
Along with Wyatt Bell.
So far, we've been in the double tight set pretty much the entire game, and West DePere has brought some extra linemen up, moved their linebackers up, brought the outside linebacker on the line of scrimmage, and they're essentially saying, hey, you're going to have to beat us some way other than running the ball between the tackles.
We have an official timeout.
It's probably going to be third and six, huh? Third and at least, yeah, third and six. Where they marked that. There was an official timeout on the field. We had Jacob Range lost his fanny pack, so they're going to run that back to the sidelines. All right, fans get up here on the near side, third and six. Pistol formation, Jacob Range, man in motion. Jet sweep to the dinger, Wyatt Bell moving towards first down yardage. He's fighting, he's got the first down yardage. The ball's on the ground, and I think West Appear has it, and they do.
Yep, fumble recovered by number two, Nolan Matthews, the defensive back, and that's a big early play of the game for the Phantoms.
Yeah, it's one of those deals where he's trying to get an extra yard, and they just knock it out of there. We might be able to take a look at that again. We shall see. Let's take a look at that again and see how he fumbled that football. All right, there he is. He's right there. He's got the first down. He's fighting, and they just knock it out of there. I think that was Thomas Mudd who knocked that free. Now the West Appear in a bit of business there in Wildcat territory already. Hand it off to Mitchell. Right up the middle. Gains a tough three or four. Second down and six. Mitchell, couple turnovers early.
Yep. Mitchell doesn't hesitate. He hits the hole fast, so you better get him early.
Second down and seven now. Yeah, we said 5'10", 181.
Yeah, and that last play was a page out of the Wildcats playbook there. They just slid the guard over from the left side to the right, ran right up the A gap, and got a gain of three yards.
Shovel now, kind of a pistol formation, flanked by Mitchell in the backfield. Now we have a receiver in motion. Give it to Mitchell. Bounces it to the outside. I think he's got first down yardage. He's working hard. He gains about eight or nine, and a first down for Nijay Mitchell. West Appear, yeah, they got a pretty good running game. They got a big offensive line. How about that offensive line? I mean, 6'4", 230, 6'5", 240. They got some big units
they do.
On that
that's,
front line.
That's as big of an offensive line as I think we've seen all season, Kevin.
Is that a college offensive line? My Lord. First and 10 now for West Appear. Back to pass. Shovel looking, crossing route. Got a man caught down there by Ryder Lesage. Good coverage by Johnson down there, but pretty good pass and catch.
He's their leading receiver, first team all-conference player. That's generally the first option for Shovel, and he put it right on him that time.
He did. First and 10, West Appear now in the red zone. They're on the 17-yard line. Duke Schovold directing traffic. Now he's going to get up under center. Nijay Mitchell in the backfield. He's the lone back. They're going to give it to him. Bounces it to the outside. Great open field tackle. Oh, baby. Oh, what a tackle.
Really nice job that time again by the senior captain, Gavin Cole.
Boy, if you look up tackle in the book there, that's a shoulder to the midsection, wrap and drive. Gain of one. It'll be second and nine. Second down and nine.
Just to point out, West Appear has a very, very good field goal kicker on their team as well. He's 45 for 45 on extra points this year.
He's warming up on the sidelines. 4:40 to go here, quarter number one. There's no score in the game. There's been a couple turnovers. Nobody yet has been able to punch one in. West Appear knocking on the door. Direct snap, Mitchell. Then we got a flag on the play. That came from the backfield. Got a face mask on River Falls preliminary call.
Yeah, they did that against New Richmond a couple of times. They put Nijay Mitchell at behind center in an empty set, kind of a wildcat formation. And
personal foul face mask as well.
He runs it.
Automatic first down, halfway distance, half the distance to the goal line. Now down to the 7-yard line. And West Appear knocking on the door here, looking to get the first score of the game. Wildcats looking to stiffen up here and keep them out of the end zone.
First and goal.
You good over there, Jeff?
Yeah. Yep, I'm good.
Okay. First and goal from the 7. Man in motion. Give it to Mitchell. Bounces it to the outside. Johnson on the first hit, and then Mitchell makes it to the end zone and a touchdown for West DePere. Najee Mitchell runs one in, a tough 7 yards, makes it to the end zone, and West DePere goes up 6-0 here with 4:12 to go in quarter number one.
Yep, usually in a game like this, turnovers are going to tell the story, and both teams have had one turnover so far. River Falls could not capitalize on theirs. West DePere does, and
they go 48 yards and convert it into six. Kicker's in. Kick is up. It is banged through and good.
People kick. Clear defense back behind the field there.
That's Bryce Smith doing the kicking for West DePere. He bangs that through. That was a no doubt extra point. It was good, but good from 40. And with 4:12 to go here in quarter number one, the West DePere Phantoms take that turnover and go down 48 yards and put a six spot up on the board. Some nice passing, some nice running, throw a penalty in there, and then a nice run to finish it off.
Yeah, good strong drive. Like you said, a couple passes, but mostly Najee Mitchell runs, and Wildcats playing from behind again for the second consecutive game.
Yeah, last week the Wildcats were down 21-12 and then rallied back with a straight 24 points, so a lot of football left to be played tonight.
One thing Nate pointed out before the game, the Wildcats have been very resilient this season. So they typically don't let deficits get them down too much. We'll see what they have tonight.
Watch the fake onside kick.
Always.
And there's a real onside kick. And they
there
got
it.
Is.
They got it. That thing took a perfect hop for West DePere. And is there a flag on the play?
No flags.
And West DePere gets that on the onside kick. That went absolutely perfect. And we might get another look at that, Braden. Let's look at that again.
If you take a look at this play, you'll notice that the DePere team looks over to the sidelines before they started the kick.
That took a perfect hop. That thing hopped just perfect. And they get the onside kick. Now the refs are conferring. Let's see. I think that's going to stand. I didn't see any flags.
Yeah, my assumption is that the coaching staff is taking a look.
Well, here comes a flag.
No, they're going to pick it up.
Oh, they are picking it up.
Yeah. My assumption is that the coaching staff is looking at the alignment of the Wildcats receiving team, and we were probably 14 yards back, and they said, let's go for it.
Someone was commenting that the score was on the wrong team, but we got that straightened out. We're good. All right, first and 10 on a great onside kick. I mean, that was you could kick it 50 times and hardly ever get the hop like that. That was perfect, and it was well executed by West DePere. Good job, Nate. Good calling, Nate. You saw that before it happened. Now we got a flag on the play. I think maybe a false start on this end. What do we got?
Lineman moved early, so that'll make it first and 15.
Yep. So, Nate, you were tipped off on that onside kick by the look at the sidelines, what you said.
Yeah. I watched a film from New Richmond, and they seem to fake the reverse on kick returns every time, and they fake the onside every time when they're kicking. This time they chose to continue with the onside and not fake it.
First and 15. Shovel, back to pass, screen. Got his man right in the middle. That is Caleb Cameron, I believe, number 21, who moves it forward for about 17 yards and moved the chains for West DePere.
Yeah, one thing that the Phantoms like to do is they definitely do a great job of using the screen game. They'll throw it to Mitchell out of the backfield often. And there's another screen on that play for a big pickup.
He'll also use the wide receiver screen as well. Mm-hmm. They probably ran four or five of them last weekend.
Fresh set of downs now. Nose of the ball rests on the 29-yard line for the Phantoms of West DePere. Shovel hands it off to Mitchell. Moves it forward for about set five. They're going to mark him after a gain of five. It'll be second and five now for West DePere. Maverick Kaminsky on the tackle. I guess maybe they'll give him a three. Gain of four. Okay. I'm all around it, guys. It's now second and six.
Pretty crucial early game possession here for the Wildcat defense.
I think so.
You don't want to go down 14 against a team this powerful.
I think you're right. Shovel Back to pass, rolling to his right, looking, got a man in the flat. That's caught. 15 down to the 10-yard line. Pass caught by number 21, Caleb Cameron on the catch and run.
Nice play design there by the Phantoms. Two wide receivers on the bottom of your screen, and they both run go routes to clear out that side and bring the other receiver underneath.
First and goal. First and goal now. Ball's at the 10. No room for a first down. They got to get it in here. Duke Schovold hands it off to Mitchell. Got him in the backfield. Now he gets out of that and gains a tough yard. It'll be second and goal from the, let's call it the 8.
Good job again by the Wildcat defense. Swarming the ball carrier led by number 29, the senior Gavin Cole.
Yeah, Jeff, really good pursuit. I tell you, that's where Mitchell hurts you. He comes up the middle, gets behind that big offensive line, and just makes a jump cut to the outside. And last week against New Richmond, he was gone a couple of times. So really, really nice job by the Wildcats on that play.
They line up right there. You can see it's about at the 8-yard line. That's where they are. Once again, Mitchell. Right up in the middle, gains another 2, and that'll be third and goal from the 6. Like you said, Jeff, this big plays right here.
Yeah, they are. Again, they're almost guaranteed 3 points with the quality of their field goal kicker, but definitely want to keep them out of the end zone here this early in the game.
I would put a wager down that says they are not going to kick it on this possession.
I like that. You think you're going to put this in the arm of Schovold right
think
here?
I think it's a four-down territory for sure for them, yeah.
Especially if you're willing to onside kick like they were early in the game.
Fans up here on the near side for River Falls, trying to implore the defense. Looking for a big play. West Appear looking to go up big early. Schovel rolls out to his right. Got a man.
Good play.
Knocked down. Nice play by Jacob Gilbertson. Got his hand right in there, guys.
Well, and here comes the field goal unit, so we'll see if they actually kick it though.
We'll see.
Someone says this has to be a production company broadcasting for them, no?
No, this is
a volunteer effort.
Five volunteers that...
We have a school principal, we have a utility director, and a bank president. And an 18-year-old kicks up. It looks good, and it is good. Bang through.
That's Bryce Smith from West Appear, their kicker. First team all-conference again. 45 of 45 during the season on his extra points, and... That was basically a extra point as well.
Is it a moral victory to hold them to 3 after that? I suppose. Right?
Absolutely. That's a win. That's a win for the Wildcats defense. Absolutely.
I think so. Down 10-0 now and minute 37 to go in quarter number 1. Boy, that onside kick worked so well last time. I don't know. I might try that again. That thing would hit just perfect. But, yeah, they don't hit like that too often. But.
No, they caught the Wildcats a little unprepared, I thought, for that. And certainly don't think a team's going to do that this early in the game, but Phantoms came here to win, obviously.
They came here to win, and that's one of those deals, too, where that kicker's been practicing that, and he says, hey, coach, I can get that to hop straight up on the third bounce. And he's like, are you sure? He said, watch me. And he did.
He did it.
Perfect.
You know, on the defensive side, on a ball like that, you go get it. You don't have to wait defensively for it to travel 10 yards like the offense does or the kicking team.
This time they're going to kick it deep. That's going to make the end zone. Karras fields it in the end zone. And the Wildcats will set up shop first and 10 on their own 20-yard line. Pretty good kick there, too.
It's got a leg. Keep that in mind later in the game if it's close.
Well, let's keep an eye on whether Jonas Severson comes back onto the field. The last time he limped off and Charlie Lesh came on for him.
He's on.
And there he is, yep, and he seems to be running fine at the moment.
Yeah.
Kakana and Homestead, we have a lightning delay. Kickoff currently scheduled for 7:39 p.m.
Wow. Thanks, David. Appreciate your comment. All right, Wildcats, first and 10 on their own 20-yard line. Under center, give it to Severson. Falls forward for 5. A good blocking up front that time, Nate. Got a little bit of a hole, and Severson's eyes got kind of big. Even going, wow, I got some room.
Yeah, that was one where they had a lot of guys on the line of scrimmage, kind of like a short yardage situation. And if you can get past the first wave, you got a chance to break a big one. Someone must have just tripped him up barely.
Second down, and let's call it a long five. I'm going to call it five. There's a nose of the ball, rests on the 25. They have to get to the 30.
Back to the two-receiver look this play, Kevin. They took Eli Johnson, the tight end, out of the game. So we have Jordan Karras.
Three-receiver look. Look at that.
Mishevsky also lined up as a receiver.
Now you've got a motion fake. Now we got a whistle, and play is stopped. Timeout, River Falls. Yeah, you had Wyatt Bell in motion. They faked the jet sweep. It was going to be a pass play, and now we got a timeout called. Second timeout by the River Falls Wildcats.
It's an interesting formation. I don't think I've seen that one all year.
Yeah, a new wrinkle it looked like for sure.
Hey, guys, you know, someone on his line is like, hey, this is not a professional broadcast, but if you want to drop, I'll just pass the offering plate around, and if you want to put a dollar in the offering plate, you can. So feel free. There's our Venmo address. We always got to buy new gear. Hey, and Todd Frisch and Gary Langer, no making change in the offering plate when it comes by.
Yes, all right? Exactly.
And I know Gary likes to make change for a 10 quite often, but not tonight, Gary.
Well, same formation. Nope. Now they're going to go to the other side, it looks like.
Second down and five. Pistol formation. Now we got the man in motion again. Fake the jet sweep. Rangers are going to keep it. Moves it forward. Ball's on the ground again. Another turnover. Wildcats may have luckily got on that. I think they did. So each team says they have it. West Appear looks really confident they have it. And let's see. They're unfurling.
We've still got two guys piles unfurling. Fighting for the ball right
filing
now.
Yep.
And they gave it to DePere.
West DePere has it.
Second turnover on the day for the Wildcats. In their own territory.
Okay. Nice run there by Jacob Range. Again, he had the first down yardage, and on the last hit, the ball comes out on the carpet. And Wildcats had a shot at it briefly, but West Appear got the football, and they are in business now on the Wildcat 39. Second turnover of the night for River Falls.
Yeah, very similar to the last Wildcat possession where they had a nice run for a first down and just coughed up the ball at the end.
First and 10. Now the defense has really got to stiffen up. Schovold, pistol formation. Back to pass, looking across the middle. Nice defense there by Reese Yonke. Not till after a gain of five.
Yeah, really nice play that time by Reese Yonke. He's been so solid all season long and did a good job that time with the tackle.
Second and five now for West DePere. Going to need a big play here, guys. Going to have to find a way to knock one free, get a turnover, and I think West DePere is just going to let it run out here, and that'll be it for quarter number one. One quarter of play in the books. It is the West DePere Phantoms 10, the Wildcats nothing, and that's it for quarter number one. Let's go thank our main sponsor, First National Bank of River Falls, with a fresh new video right out of the... We're going to drop it right here. Thank you, First National Bank of River Falls. That was clever. 34 years ago, last time Wildcats were at level three. That's what you were wearing, and you were rewinding your cassette tapes with a pencil.
Life was much simpler back then, Kevin.
It was.
No phones, no internet.
That was cute. Nice job on that commercial. Marketing department down at the First National Bank of River Falls. All right, here we go. Second down and five. Back to pass, Schovold looking, still looking. Rainbow down the near side. He's got a man just out of the outstretched arms of Ryder Lesage.
Boy, he's got an arm on him, Nate, doesn't he?
He does. You know, and he makes good reads. I just really like how he stands tall in the backfield there in the pocket and reads the field. And He's well coached, and he's got a good arm.
Nate, he's only a junior, too.
Yeah, good player.
Nate, I'm going to give you another shot here. Four down territory.
Oh, absolutely. They're not kicking it from here, Kevin.
We'll give you another chance.
Okay.
All right, third and five. West Appear takes that turnover, looking to try to turn it into points. Wildcats defense knows they've got to stiffen up here. Shovel, pistol formation. He's got it. She's going to keep it. Bounces it to the outside and back up the middle, headed towards first down yardage. I think by looking at the officials, I think he's got it.
I think he does. That's something you don't see very often, Duke Schovald running with the football and cut the Wildcats by surprise there.
I'm not even sure it was a design play. It looked like it was a bad snap, and they missed the handoff, and he said, I'm just going to keep it.
Now we're in some hurry-up, Kevin.
Hurry-up offense. Two receivers here to the near side, one tight end here to the near side. Mitchell in the backfield. Mitchell will get it. Bounces up through the middle. Gains three or four. We'll call it three. It'll be second and seven.
Been a while since Najee Mitchell ran with the football. And
number seven, Brody Rudolph.
Sandy Worm's watching for Monomedy with Mike Worm and Jack Cohen. And Carroll. Welcome aboard. All right, here we go. Second down and seven. 10-0. It's been all West Appear thus far, and a couple turnovers and an onside kick. Looking to punch another one in. Wildcats looking to do something big here on defense. Crossing route. Got a man. Oh, in and out of the hands of the intended receiver. That was Bryce Smith. Shovel's got a pretty good arm.
He does. He's got a cannon on him. The receiver had several inches on. Looks like Bryce Bevin was in the coverage there.
Just a simple cross route, right? You see some of the...
Nothing fancy.
You know, the college and pro teams do that. You just get the seven-yard slant cross. You get inside leverage on your defender. And you try to, if you can get the pass there, you make a play. Third and seven. Here we go. Big play. Probably two downs to make seven. Schovel, back to pass. Got him in the flat. Caught and taken down again by Gavin Cole on the far side. Great open field tackle. That's going to go for no gain, fellas.
Yeah, Gavin's keeping us in the game defensively, really. He's had three big plays now already that I can think of. And again, Phantom's going to that screen pass, Nate.
Yep. A really good read by our defense and Gavin in particular. They must have seen that and filmed and coached up the kids. But that was a screen, wide receiver screen pass that went for nothing.
Big play. He might have even lost half a yard. It's a fourth and a long seven now. Schovel. Three receivers here to the near side, and now we're still directing traffic from the sidelines. Five receivers out. It's like a flag football game. Schovel back to pass. Looking. Still looking. Crossing. Right.
Picked off!
Is that Mischewski?
Yes, it is.
The muscle! Kate Mischewski! Gets his big paws up there, reels it into the six, rumbles and stumbles forward, back to the 32. Big hold for the Wildcats there.
A great read by first-team all-conference player Cade Mischewski. That's Schovald's only his third interception of the entire season on 211 throws.
Wow. Mischewski just reading the quarterback's eyes, sits down right in the right spot. We'll take a look at that again right here. Back to pass. Schovald had time. Mischewski, look at Mischewski read, and boom, right in front of that defender, and nice job hanging on to the football, covering the points. First and 10, River Falls.
I'm not sure Schovald even saw him.
No. Fake handoff, back to pass. Now he's scrambling, looking, going deep down the far side, and that is incomplete. Some people looking for a penalty there. A lot of traffic, a lot of collisions, and no call. Coach Ryan Shears wanted a penalty as well. Nothing called.
Incomplete. You know, that from my perspective up here, I don't think that's a pass interference. I think there's a number of guys going for the football. I think contact's happening at roughly the same time.
Yeah. And a titch underthrown as
right,
well.
Right.
So there's that to mix in there.
I believe the pass was intended for Severson, which kind of an odd formation because they had a couple of receivers right in the area, it looked like.
Kind of a go route of the running back, huh? All right, second and 10.
Under center this time.
Under center. Mischewski and Severson in the backfield. They're just going to go power left here. Severson pounds it forward for a tough 6 yards. That's the old school football we've seen all season long from the Wildcats right there. They just go power right and run behind right behind the bigs and Cade Mishewski. They pounded forward for seven.
At least it puts them in a manageable third down position here where they can either run the football, give it to Severson, or throw it. We'll see what Coach Scherz and his staff decide what to do here.
Third and four. I guess third and manageable, I guess. Playbook's fairly thick. Single coverage up top. No safety deep. Let's keep an eye on that. Severson play action. He's in big trouble, though, is Jacob Range, and he is down, and he's sacked in the backfield. Sacked by number five, Shane Kempen, on the sack there for West DePere. He got there quick. Someone missed an assignment. He got in on the far side and sacked.
That's certainly what it looked like. Shane Kempen, 6'1", 210-pound linebacker, and basically looked untouched from where I was standing.
Yeah, he's an outside linebacker, and when they go to a double set, just like against New Richmond, Kempen would often come up on the line and blitz, and I felt like that was a one-receiver route there, guys, and hoping to bite on the play action didn't happen with number five right in Jacob Rain's grill.
So lost four there. It'll be fourth and eight, punt time. Severson to punt. Oh, he's hit. I think maybe by his own guy. And ball's rolling down near the 22.5-yard line. No flag. I don't know if our guy was blocked into our punter. It's what it looked like there. Is that what you had, guys?
Let's take a look at that again.
We'll take a look here, see.
That's what I saw.
Yeah, he was blocked into him.
Yep.
Eight for the Wildcats. I think it was Cody Olson was blocked into Severson.
Right.
It's a good job getting that away, and it was a pretty good punt, as it turned out.
Hey, we got another visitor. I've got a shout-out here from the state of Oregon. Madeline and Amber Sherman are tuning in, watching the game.
Outstanding. Kind of like it. Yeah, it wasn't a bad punt. Actually, like 45 yards on the roll.
Mitchell again. Good job by the Wildcat defense in pursuit there.
Now, considering he was blocked into, I thought it was maybe going to be like a 15-yard punt, but it got all the way down to the 21-yard line.
Second and seven.
A couple of shout-outs here, Kevin. Sean Johnson watching the game along with my good friend John Handel, also watching the game from Elkhorn, Wisconsin. Welcome aboard.
Second down and seven. Shoveled. Crossroad. Got a man sitting down right in the zone. Nice catch. Now a run by Ryder LeSage. Trying to find the edge and then pushed out of bounds on the far side.
Pretty easy pitch and catch right there. LeSage wide open in the middle of the field and was able to run after the catch for a nice gain.
Zach Peterson from the Wildcats pushed him out of bounds on the far side, but not until he racked up about 20 yards. Fresh set of downs, first and 10 on their own 49. First and 10. Shovel hands it off to Mitchell. Bounces it back here across grain. If he gets a block, he's going to get some positive yards. Nice job shedding the blocks there, but he ran a long ways to gain eight, but he'll take the 8.5 that he gained. Good athletic run there by Najee Mitchell. Breaks out of the pile, just comes to the far side. He got a couple chip blocks and ran it ahead for, I guess, nine. It'll be second and one.
Yeah, good example of his shiftiness there, boy. He can scoot and side to side. He's no slouch either.
Could have been a lot worse, I thought.
For sure.
I was nervous he was going to take that one to the house.
Yeah, because he had a wall set up there. Second and one. Give it to Mitchell again. He's got first down yardage and more. Pounding it forward. Nice open field tackle by Johnson, Preston Johnson. The safety has to step up and make the play.
Got to tackle Mitchell low there. Did a good job of...
Good leverage.
Low. Good low on him, but it is enough for a phantom first down.
We have an official timeout on the field now. It seems right now that the West DePere Phantoms are kind of getting it cranked up, aren't they? A little bit.
Yeah, they're kind of having their way with us at the moment.
First and 10. Mitchell again to the outside. He's quick. He's elusive. Nice tackle by Johnson again. Two consecutive tackles by Preston Johnson, the sophomore.
I think that one saved a touchdown, probably.
Potentially.
If he got around the corner, he was gone.
We talked about that a few games ago. When you start calling the safety's number too many times on tackles, that's never a good sign.
Nope, you're right. It's happened a few times to the Wildcats this season.
Second down and four now. Nijay Mitchell's getting loose. He's getting rid of the bus legs. Getting loose. Mitchell again cuts it back up in the middle, headed towards first down yardage. I think he has it. Gain of about five on the play. That'll be enough for a phantom first down. Move the chains again for West DePere.
Johnson again on a tackle along with Cade Mischewski, number six.
Yeah, what DePere is doing right now, they're spreading out our defense a little bit with their wide receivers, two wide receiver set, forcing our linebackers to play a little deeper and a little wider and putting a lot of pressure on our defensive line to hold their gaps, which they haven't been able to do thus far.
Shovel's just going to give it up the middle to Mitchell again, and they're pounding the rock right now, gain of six, second and four.
Cade Mischewski again on the tackle there. Good first down gain for the Phantoms. Putting a lot of pressure on the Wildcat defense right now.
Gain of five, second and five.
Second down and five. Got a good look right across the field there from our new addition this week, our on-field camera. John Fry down there getting it done. Shoveled. He's going to keep it, roll out to his right. Has a man in the flat. 10, 5, touchdown, Phantoms. Nothing too fancy. Good fake at the line. Nice job by Shoveled rolling out, finding his guy, and then it's just good individual effort. Was that Ryder Lesage on that? Or was it Bryce Smith?
We got a replay. Here we go.
Let's take a look and see who that was. After the extra point. I want to get the number right. Give the kids some credit. Nice play. This is Bryce Smith doing the kicking. That even sounded good. That's up and through. And with 4:40 to go, 17-0 Phantoms over the Wildcats. Let's go back and take a look at that again and see if we can give this kid some credit for the nice run at the end of this little yak. That's 21. That's Caleb Cameron, who just getting it done for West DePere. Nice job, Caleb.
Yeah, the fake up the middle on that play causes the linebackers to take a step forward. The wide receiver on the top of the screen clears out by going to the back of the end zone, and he fills the void, and the quarterback finds him for a touchdown.
17-0. West DePere here in the first half of football. We're 4:40 to go till halftime, and the Wildcats are going to have to figure something out here soon.
Yeah, it's tough when you get down this many points, Nate. The Wildcats predominantly a run team. It usually takes them a while to score. So.
Yeah, and I don't think they have to get away from the run just yet. We're in the first half of the game, and maybe we can punch one in here, and we get the ball back after half, right, guys? Is that right?
Really close to an offsides.
Yes.
Fields it on the far side. Moves it up. Out to the 19-yard line. Does Jacob Gilbertson on the return there for River Falls.
Yeah, turnovers have been the story tonight. The Phantoms have capitalized on theirs, and the Wildcats have not, hence they're up by 17 points right now.
Come the Wildcats in their next possession. Need to find a way to matriculate here, get some points for the Wildcats. Jacob Range, pistol formation, flanked by Severson. Range is going to keep it here to the near side. Cut it back up in there. That's going to be a tough yard.
Ball game number one, Jacob Range.
I don't even think he got one. We're going to call it no gain, second and 10.
Again, great pursuit by the Phantom defense. No room to run at all that time.
Second down and 10. Range, back to pass, now looking, rolling out to his left, in a bit of trouble. Doesn't get back to the line of scrimmage. That'll go down as another West DePere sack.
Jake Range, taking out number 31.
Yeah, that play was just a little bit slow developing, I think, Jeff. You know, the reverse rollout, by the time he turns around, he's got pressure. And against this defensive line, I don't know that we're going to be able to turn our back and then regain our line of sight to make a good quality pass.
No, the very, very good team speed for West DePere. Jacob Breyer with the tackle that time. Brings up another third long, Kevin.
Third and 12. Third and 12, three receivers here to the near side. Jacob Range flanked. The dinger, Wyatt Bell's going to get it on a jet sweep, tries to move it forward and taken down, knocked at the line of scrimmage by a big West DePere player, and gets baby back to the original line of scrimmage. It's going to be fourth and 10.
So Joseph Joyner with the play that time brings up another fourth down. Punt time for the Wildcats.
Yeah, it looked like Wyatt had one guy to beat there to maybe get around the corner, and the DePere player just really did a nice job pushing his blocker right back into the cutting lane, and I'm not sure he made the tackle, but he pushed his blocker into Wyatt
right,
and caused him to fall down. Great job on the defensive side.
Yeah, chat section is getting a little bit salty. Guys, just keep it decent. And that, so we were talking about punts last time, but that was not that wasn't a good punt. That was 15 yards after the bad roll. So West DePere will set up shop first and 10 on their own 30, on the Wildcat 38-yard line.
Three timeouts left for the Phantoms with 2:13. Plenty of time for them. Potentially a time here for Coach Schurz to take a timeout if he needs to right his defense. This is a huge possession here for both teams.
First and 10 for West DePere. Schovold back to pass, going for the jugular. Got a man in and out of the hands of the intended receiver and then the defender for River Falls, and it falls incomplete. Yeah, going right for the throat right there, guys, trying to get one quick strike.
Yep, exactly. They're not messing around.
They're a good football team, right? They come on, drive across the state, and they got a quality squad, no doubt about it. River Falls has their hands full. Both teams 10-1 on the season, but this is the biggest team we've seen all year, no doubt about that.
Biggest and I would say fastest, too.
Oh, yeah. They're a full package. Back to pass is shoveled again. Screen. Set up perfectly and falls incomplete. They had the salmon swimming upstream there, and that thing was set up to go for some yards and just overthrown the intended receiver.
Yeah, Wildcats caught a huge break right there because they had that thing perfectly set up, like you said, Kevin, and just overthrown by Schovald that time.
You know, sometimes when you're running a screen as a lineman, you're supposed to chip your defensive lineman, hold him for a second, and then let him go. And Mashevsky luckily was able to get some quick pressure on the quarterback, forcing him to throw a high ball, and that was our good fortune on that play.
Third down and 10. Schovald, empty backfield, looking. Deep cross, got his man. That is Joseph Reisenberg, I believe, number 19, who catches it for first down yardage. Gain of about 15 or 16 on the play. That was Reisenberg on the catch there. Preston Johnson with another tackle for River Falls.
Like you said earlier, our secondary is making way too many tackles tonight, Kevin.
And yeah.
Marching at the door again, West DePere.
Knocking on the door, ball. Now we can say they're in the red zone one more time. Buck 40 to go till the half. Wildcats trying to hold them out. They do have all three of their timeouts remaining. Schovold's going to keep it on the edge. We got the edge sealed off pretty good. Gain of about four on the play, maybe three is where he stepped out. It'll be second and seven. Clock will stop with a buck 31 to go here till the half. It's been pretty much all West Appear here in half number one in River Falls, Wisconsin.
Down to the 17-yard line. Second set.
West Appear with all three timeouts left, Kevin.
All three, plenty of time. Time clock, not a factor with that situation there. Second and seven. Schovel, screen here to the near side. He's got blockers out in front, headed towards the promised land. He's in, touchdown, West Appear. Boy, that was a well set up play, Nate.
Yeah, fake to the right, brought it back to the left, and you get it in Mitchell's hands behind some blockers on this position of the field, and the result is
let's take a look at that
touchdown.
Right, I mean, look at this wall they had set up. They screened it back here to the near side, guys, and look at the wall. That was going to score any day of the week. Oh, pretty. Jack Eastman runs that in for West Appear, and just like that, 23-0. Looking to put a 24 up spot up here. Bryce Smith, the kicker. Boy, he's got a good-looking leg, and he nails that through. And with 124 to go here in half number one,
score. West Appear
24, River Falls nothing. They got a good team.
They do, yep. Like we've said earlier, they're by far the best team we've seen this season. They're big, they're strong, they're fast. They pretty much have everything. Good quarterback, good running back, well-conceived offense, and their defense has been solid tonight.
Yeah, the thing I like about their offense is the diversity they bring. You know, they're able to run the ball. They can throw the ball to their tight ends and their running backs. Their receivers are doing a really nice job getting behind the linebackers, staying in front of the safeties, who are playing pretty far off to prevent a big play. And Schovald's just kind of picking them apart. A lot of time to throw. A good club.
I hear someone online says Mitchell's going to Duluth, but he could have maybe walked on to some Big Ten school, they're saying here. That's what the West Appear folks are saying.
Yeah, he definitely has the speed for that. There's no doubt about that.
6'1", 178, good sized individual.
Can gain some weight, I'm sure. And
Yeah,
4.37, that's
can't
that's
teach
moving.
That.
You know, I ran a 4.37 once, but it was 20 yards, not 40.
Right. Bottle up there at the 20-yard line. And
yeah, their team speed, even on that kickoff right there, their kick coverage, Phantoms had three or four players right down inside the 20-yard line to tackle.
All over the kick returner like a pack of dogs on a three-legged cat. And nowhere to go. Just swarm down.
Well, now, three timeouts, guys, and I wouldn't be surprised if West Appear uses them here to try and get a quick, get the ball back.
Range, back to pass, looking. There's a screen themselves. Severson's got it. He's got a little bit of room. It's positive yards, gain of seven.
Yeah, that was a well-conceived play right there, too. The rush came in, which they wanted them to, and good screen pass, but their team speed was able to cover that up to keep them to about a six-yard gain.
Big first down. I was a little surprised that we hurried up there, thinking maybe we would just try and get into halftime. Big first down.
Getting the first down. That was nice. All right, wind the clock now with 50-49, and here we go. Jacob Range. Again, pistol formation. Guy's going to roll off to his left. He's in big trouble. He escapes. Throw it. Got Mishevsky in the flat and falls incomplete.
Yeah, roughing the passer there. Yep.
That might have been, was that Cody Olson over there, number eight? Or it was in the flat, so my apologies. Missed him, but roughing the passer.
That was on Joseph Joyner right there. Hit Jacob a little late.
The
38 seconds. You can see what River Falls does have one timeout here remaining in the first half. Knows the ball rests on their own 45-yard line. 55 yards to go to pay dirt in 38 seconds. One timeout. Range back's got to step up in the pocket. Now he wants to run it. Not a lot Fair to go, no, and now the ball's on the ground, and I think Wester Pierce got it, and they do. With 26 seconds to go and three timeouts, Jacob Range gets the ball on the carpet there, and Wester Pierce is all over River Falls tonight.
You know, that was the second time where they got their paws in and were just ripping at the football as he's fighting for extra yards, and you can't blame Jacob for his effort, obviously, but a well-coached team, and when one guy has him held up, the other guy's job is to try and rip it. And it worked.
And we'll do that at halftime for you, David. Thank you. First and 10. Back to pass, looking. Schovold got all day directing traffic and just throws it away. Good coverage downfield by River Falls.
Yeah, good job by the secondary that time. They covered up all the receivers. And Schovold had all day to throw, but nothing going on.
Second and 10, 20 seconds. Still have their three timeouts in their pocket. I mean, Schovold's got the arm, right? He's going to probably bring it, go for the home run ball here, guys. What do you think? Did you hear Nate?
20 seconds, three timeouts. They don't have to yet, but they might.
Schovold back to pass. A little short cross.
Inside receiver screen.
Ryder Lesage moves it forward for about 9. Now they'll take a timeout right here.
Ryder Lesage. Number 6,
11 seconds left. Again, they got a very good field goal kicker, so we're probably pretty darn close to his range right now.
Yeah.
And with the timeout, they have the whole field to work with. They don't have to throw just to the sidelines. The middle of the field is available to Wester Pierce should they choose to throw it there, and plenty of time to get a playoff and shorten the distance, take a timeout, and attempt a field goal.
We did have someone ask to put that back up again. So, yeah, we're a volunteer deal and got equipment to replace every now and then. So if we'll throw the offering plate around it again if you want. Go ahead. So I appreciate the kind words. We're trying to do the best we can to celebrate both teams and bring in some good high school football. It's been a good one for Wester Pierce thus far.
Yeah, the four-hour trip over here didn't seem to bother him a whole lot.
No. And,
they certainly came here ready to play right out of the chute, and it's a very, very impressive squad that Coach Chris Greason has put together.
Well, and credit to them. They've taken a four-hour trip 2 weeks in a row.
Right.
You know, and at this point of the season, there's a cumulative effect on the legs of the players, not just getting banged around, but sitting in a bus that long.
Yep, for sure.
Third and 2. Schovold in a bit of trouble, almost had him. Now he's going to roll out. He's got some green grass in front of him, eyes downfield, makes a nice pass, and then really nice catch by Ryder Lesage.
Wow.
He's good. 3 seconds. Got just enough time to go for one play to the end zone here.
Or they'll kick a field goal, which I think is what you're going to see here, Kevin. We're looking at about 33-yard field goal here.
You know, going back to that last play, guys, really nice job by the quarterback eluding the rush, rolling out to the right, keeping his eyes downfield, and then great job by the receiver. His job is to get across the face of the quarterback so he can be seen, so he doesn't have to throw back across his body. And that player, I don't remember which number that was, ran all the way across the field, caught it right at the sideline, and got out of bounds.
Yeah, that was Lesage.
Yeah.
I think you hit on it, Nate, keeping his eyes downfield. Schovold does a fantastic job of that. That's very evident so far this evening, where he doesn't watch the rush coming at him. He's always looking downfield, and he's a good one.
Yeah, and he had room to run there, too, but you know, he knew where the line of scrimmage was, and just, like you said, kept his eyes downfield, sees the guy 20 yards down there, so he's going to throw it.
Yep.
Trusts his receivers, and Ryder Lesage is a good one as well. All right, here we go. We're going to have ourselves a, 34-yarder?
Fake.
Up the middle. Runs it forward. They don't get it.
Hmm.
And that'll run out the clock here in half number one. So with one half of play in the books here from David Smith Stadium at Raymer Field on the campus of the University of Wisconsin River Falls, it is the Wester Pierce Phantoms 24, the Wildcats. Nothing. And pretty good half right there for Wester Pierce. Hey, as I look for our Wildcat trivia warm-up music, we want to thank our main sponsor again, Sarah Jenkins. She's our sponsor of tonight's game. So thank you, Property Executives Realty, Sarah Jenkins. If you haven't been to sarahjenkins.com, go check that out. She's got some great weekly real estate update videos on there. So we're gonna. It's time for Wildcat Trivia. We got a dandy tonight. So thank you, Ariel Avestres, for putting this together. We're gonna go to Wildcat Trivia. Tonight, we're going to be playing once again for one of those delicious Charlie Cat chicken sandwiches down at the Tarnation Tavern. I want to thank Fred Barr and Colleen down there at the Tarnation Tavern for serving up those delicious Charlie Cat sick chicken sandwiches. I'm telling you right now, they are as good as they look in the picture. That is not fake advertising there. They are as good as they look. So here we go, everybody. Get to the edge of your seat for some Wildcat Trivia. So River Falls, including this year, has been in the playoffs 13 times with 10 wins and 12 losses. West De Pere has had an amazing 25 playoff berths with a 45-22 record. Which team has faced both River Falls and West De Pere in Wisconsin football playoff history? They've got one mutual team that they both played. So let's see, you can get up on the Wildcat chat. You can win yourself one of those Charlie Cat chicken sandwiches if you know the team that they both played. Playoffs. So who in the playoffs? So what was the team? Pulaski, not right. Kaukauna, nope. Menominee, nope. Kettle Moraine, no. Tori Prigge says New Richmond, nope. Marshfield, nope. Nope, not New Richmond, not Menasha, not Menominee. Not Pulaski. So which team has faced both River Falls and West De Pere in the football playoffs? Wanakee, no. Not New Richmond. Appleton, no. Got people running up to the booth, no. The question again is, which team has faced both River Falls and West De Pere in football playoff history? La Crosse Central, no. Hudson, no. Wanakee, no. Ashwaubenon, no. Holman, no. Should I give the year for a hint? Is it too early to give a hint?
Probably.
Too early.
La
Crosse Central? No.
Nope. Sun Prairie? No. Holman, I'm getting a bunch of guesses here, too. De Pere? No.
There's 560 school districts in the state of Wisconsin, sooner or later.
Yeah, someone's going to get one. Okay, I'm going to tell you, it was before 1990. How about that?
Okay.
It was before 1990.
So it's hard to look up on wisports.net. That's where a lot of people get their answers from.
Right. Ashwaubenon? No.
They're just being resourceful,
yes.
Jeff.
Yes, well, I've...
It was before,
might have won a few contests that way myself.
Yeah, it was before 1990. Oconomowoc, no. Debbie Avestres doesn't know the answer. Yeah, because your husband put the question together.
Debbie.
She's on the edge of her seat. She's yelling at her TV right now. So I'm going to answer it. Chippewa Falls, no. Logan, no.
Menominee, no.
Eau Claire Memorial, no.
Freedom, no. Bayport, no. Lakeland, no. I'll say this. It's kind of between River Falls and West De Pere.
Kind of.
La Crosse, Logan, no.
Medford, no. Mark Spafford says Superior, no.
No.
Kimberly, no. Wisconsin Rapids, no. I mean, when you could talk Wisconsin Rapids, you're kind of now in the area code-ish. Antigo, we got it. Laura Lehman has got it. It's Antigo. Laura Lehman, you're the winner of one of those delicious Charlie Cat chicken sandwiches. I'll let Fred Barr know you're the winner. A little more interesting facts on that game. So Antigo played the Wildcats in the sectional semifinal in 1986. The Redbirds played West De Pere in level one in 2012 and 2018. River Falls' own adopted son, Todd Frisch, quarterbacked Antigo for the win against the Wildcats 21-7.
What?
If you ever see Todd, ask him about his special helmet. So Todd Frisch was the quarterback for Antigo that beat River
First
Falls.
String? First string quarterback?
I didn't think he was tall enough to play quarterback.
And he's really our adopted son, too.
Yeah, I guess. Our adopted son here in River Falls. West De Pere was crowned state champions in 2010, 2011, and took second in 2009 and 2018. No matter how you slice it, dice it, multiply it, or divide it, they're definitely a playoff powerhouse. West De Pere. So there you go. That was kind of fun. Wildcat trivia.
That was good.
Antigo. Todd Frisch, quarterback Antigo. Nice job, Ariel Avestres. I like the way he ties that all together, right? You get a playoff team.
That was a good
Absolutely.
One, too.
Really good.
We went through the entire state of Wisconsin with guesses that night.
There we go. John Fry back in the house. We got some nice shots down there, sideline. John, thank you. Great job. Cold down there? Heat's on in here. It's about 60. Let's go through some of our other sponsors. Let's go thank Jen Rivard. She's been on touchdowns for 20 all year. Joe Karras of Black Wolf Exteriors. Both Jen and Joe made a nice contribution to Sunshine Fund here last week. They just gave them $1,000 from playing our games all year long. Great job there. First National Bank of River Falls. They're always our main sponsor. Sarah Jenkins, we already mentioned her. She's our game sponsor for tonight. Thank you, Sarah Jenkins, for paying the $250 to the WIAA. You know what I think we have got time for, backed by popular demand? Wipes in the Pipes.
Hi, I'm Kevin Westhouse, your utility director. I'm here today to talk to you about WMTF. What not to flush? Because wipes clog pipes. Many of these items say flushable right on the container. Don't let that confuse you. So-called flushable products like these in this container, in this cute container, in this beautiful three-pack, you start flushing these down your toilet, you will get what is called a worldwide phenomenon, a fatberg. Fatbergs clog pipes. Other things you shouldn't be flushing down your toilet, fruit peelings, bleach, feminine products, oil or any oily substances, pills, partner products, cotton balls, and of course, Goldie the goldfish. All this talk about toilets and sewers has suddenly given me a bit of a nervous tummy. Remember, wipes clog pipes. Toilet paper only, please.
Keep it on it from here on out. You got to move a few. All right. Wipes clog pipes. Remember, toilet paper only, please. I know right in the container it says flushable. You can flush them down, but they won't flush out. You'll be calling Roto-Rooter. Then you'll have to get Chris Lick with ServPro over there to clean your basement out. You don't want to do it. So toilet paper only, please. You'll thank me later.
Well, guys, a couple of different halftime locker room talks going on probably in the River Falls and West De Pere locker rooms right now. West De Pere, man, I don't know that they could ask for anything more than what they've been able to do, and probably more of the same here in the second half, and trying to sustain the line of scrimmage and burn some clock and get out of here healthy with a win. And Wildcats opening the second half with the football, and man, just looking to get a couple of first downs and hopefully get some momentum going in their direction.
Yeah, far too many turnovers to be able to hang with a team this good as West Appear is. I think Wildcats had their opportunity early in the game. They forced a fumble on their first possession, had the ball in great field position. They
forced a punt also.
Yeah, they couldn't score. They had it within the 25-yard line and weren't able to get anything out of that. And, yeah, like you said, they forced a punt too. And it's been rough sledding for the Wildcats. Well, they do get the opening kick, correct?
Yep, so, yep. Yeah, as a coach in halftime, when you're down 24 and you've clearly been outplayed, it's a hard message, a hard thing to sell to your players. And I think you're probably just talking about one possession at a time, each play, everybody do your job. Let's, you know, try not to worry about the score at this point, but win each play.
Yep.
First down, get another first down, and see what happens here. Defensively, I don't know if they mix things up, maybe press the wide receivers a little bit and, force them to try and go deep for the long ball. You give one up. But right now they've been picking us apart underneath, and I'm not sure that's in the game plan, but might be something to consider here in the second half.
Yeah, I think we're going to see a whole lot more of Najee Mitchell, I would assume.
I would bet, yeah.
With a 24-point lead, clock is your friend for sure, and I would imagine that they'll keep the ball on the ground a lot or go to that screen game, Nate, like you said.
Yeah.
It's been extremely effective tonight.
Sure has.
How you doing over here, Braden? Braden Engstrom on production tonight. Someone tip your hat at home for Braden Engstrom. We added him this year, and it's been nothing but stellar graphics and bringing you all the good stuff, the replays and just scrolling scoreboard. He's like the maestro over here getting it done, making us all look like rock stars.
Yeah, if you take a look what this broadcast looked like a couple months ago, like
right.
We were in Wisconsin Rapids when Bo and I did that broadcast.
We call that base offense,
and,
Jeff.
Yeah, and you compare it to this, you wouldn't realize it's the same production.
Right.
We're peaking at the right time.
Yeah.
Yes. You always want to peak at the end of the year.
You know, and it should be noted that Braden not only is great with video production, he's great with photography. He can put all kinds of things together for you and your family, your kids. If you're a parent of a high school athlete looking to play college sports, Braden can put together a great hype video of your son or daughter. And I know that Jeff and I have both reaped the benefits of some of Braden's work over the years, and you should look him up.
He's good. And if you're like a small business in town ever thinking about putting a 15 or 30 second little ad together for social media or something like that, you're thinking about doing it, you just don't know how to do it, get a hold of Braden Engstrom. He can come and whip that out for you probably in an afternoon. The kid's good.
He's very good.
Yeah, so if people are listening, guys, how does someone get in touch with Braden? How do we do that? Do they contact us through our YouTube channel?
Yeah, I think so. I have River Falls Sports Broadcasting on Facebook. You can message me there as well. I think if you call the high school and talk to the principal or athletic director, we could also get you Braden's phone number through that there too.
I don't want to put that out.
No, we can put that out there right now, Braden. Your phone would light up like a Christmas tree.
Are we going to see you during basketball season, Braden? We are.
Yeah.
Outstanding. So that's right around the corner, too.
It is.
Girls start practice on Monday.
And is that right? Okay.
The boys start the following Monday.
And when does Augustana open up, Jeff?
Augustana has their first game next Friday night.
Okay.
In Kansas City.
Oh, cool. Who do they play there?
I believe their first game is Arkansas Monticello, I think they start out with.
Okay.
And then they play Saturday as well. So Zach's pretty excited about that, I know.
I would imagine.
I saw his little court interview. That was a good little segment. So they walk down the court and they get the interview. Real nice job by your son there getting that done. It was Augustana. That was good.
Talked a lot about his pink shoes that he wore when he was a junior.
SpongeBob shoes, right?
Brought back some fond memories when all the players were wearing SpongeBob shoes that year. So. And how's Bemidji doing in football this year, Nate?
Good, good. They have won 7 in a row right now. They're 7-2. They have a huge home game tomorrow against Northern State, who's won 4 in a row themselves. And right now they're the 7th seeded team in their region. The top 7 make the D2 playoffs. So essentially, Bemidji has to win out. Bemidji did beat a couple of teams that are ahead of them, but the way that they figure out the ratings is based partly on strength of schedule, and unfortunately for Bemidji, the northern half of the Northern Sun Conference just has a weaker core group of teams.
That conference is just a grind in football. Everybody's been beating each other. It's the same way in basketball. That's kind of how the WEAC is in football this year, Kevin, too, for UW-River Falls. They have one of their best teams they've had in many, many years, and unfortunately there's a ton of good teams in the WIAC this season.
A ton. That was a heartbreak city. Last week, River Falls down in Whitewater, and they kicked one a 47-yarder, hit the crossbar, and bounced in.
The bottom crossbar, the bottom too, crossbar, which you don't see very often. And
right.
Rolled over.
Yeah.
Right.
Heartbreak City for the UW River Falls Falcons. I also want to thank the Garage Bikes and Brews. They've just been great this year with our Garage Grinder of the Game Award, and they bring out the weekly awards that are engraved for every individual week, and they've done a great job. If you haven't been down to the Garage Bikes and Brew, go visit them. It's great atmosphere down there at the Garage Bikes and Brews in River Falls.
Kevin, since we got a couple of minutes, it might be a good time to go through some of the all-conference players.
Let's do that, yes.
For football, first-team running back Jonas Severson, wide receiver Jordan Karras, tight end Cade Mashevsky, offensive lineman Maverick Kaminsky. Mm-hmm. Second-team offense, offensive lineman Landon Zepsik. First-team defense, defensive back Wyatt Bell. Defensive lineman, Cade Mashevsky, so Cade was able to make it both ways. And second-team defense, linebacker Gavin Cole made it. And I think it's important to point out that the co-coach of the year was head coach Ryan Schurz from the River Falls Wildcats.
Hey, before you go to the next one, someone's asking about Homestead and Koskana. I think they're postponed.
Actually, not. It has started, and I had a score in that game. It was delayed by lightning. Kakana's up 7-6 in the first quarter.
7-6. So, good. More all conferences, other sports.
Yeah, real quick while we're waiting for the kickoff here, cross country, Quinn Andrews was the boys' conference champion. Came in 31st at the state meet last week. He's only a sophomore. Girls first team, Lily Jensen, Olive Halverson. Second team all-conference boys, Jonah Majeris. Honorable mention, girls, Afton Gillis. Girls golf, second team all-conference, Leah McCain. And boys soccer, first team, Zach Nye and Tustin Todd, only a sophomore. Second team, Caleb Selleck. And honorable mention, Remy Espinel.
Yeah, one more. Volleyball?
I think we might have some volleyball here. Up, girls swimming.
Swimming. We'll get to
first team, Rachel Everson, Ellery Autumn a couple times for a couple of different events. First team all-conference. And we'll get to the rest in a bit.
All right. We'll hang on to the rest. We'll get to the rest of the all-conference selections here in just a bit. Call Connor just went up 13-6 on a pick six. All right, kick is away. Fielded here on the near side, back on the 7. Taking up forward, running hard out to the 37-yard line. Okay, someone shot him out of a cannon. Nice return right there by Jacob Gilbertson.
Jacob has some wheels, there's no doubt about that. He's a star in the track team and a great kickoff return to start the second half. We'll see if the Wildcats can do something with it.
10 Wildcats, 37 yards.
Came out with some want to right there, guys. First and 10. Wildcats got their work cut out for them, down 24-0 against a very good West DePere team.
A short run that time by Severson, and you can see the Phantom defense. They're clawing for the football every time somebody's running with it for River Falls, and Jonah held on to it that time.
Second down and 8 now. Wildcats will take the line. Well, down 24-0, it'd make the story pretty good, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would.
Pitch out to Severson, cuts it back, following his blockers, falls ahead for 4. Third down and 3.
Ball game 25, Jonah Severson, tripping up on the play for 9, Isaac Castor.
Pretty critical third down play this early in the third quarter. I assume we're probably in 4-down territory here, given the score of the game.
Maybe.
Down 24. Wildcat fans still got some life in them, though, here on the near side. Bring that to you a little bit. Here we go, 3rd and 3. Hand it off to Severson. That's what they do. Did he get it back?
Yeah,
he bobbled it, but he got the ball back, and that went for a loss. It'll be 4th and 4. Boy, they're ready for that. Sniffed it right out.
Jacob Range has already come off the field, so it looks like they will be punting.
Punt time here for River Falls.
Yeah, I suppose, you know, you're down 3 scores, right? 3 touchdowns, 3 2-point conversions. You give up the ball here in this field position and give up another score, and you're thinking, well, we're pretty much out of hope. So put your defense on the field, and you got to get a stop.
Oops. Punt is away, side of his foot. It gets a good River Falls roll, fielded back on the 21-yard line, now moves it forward. Good open field tackle on a 7-yard return. And that's where the West Appear Football Phantoms will take up shop. 1st and 10 here for their first possession in half number 2. Up 24-0 over the River Falls Wildcats.
Like we talked at halftime, expect to see a heavy dose of number 3, Najee Mitchell, this half. He already has 1 touchdown on the day.
First and 10. Hand it off to Mitchell. He's shifty. He's elusive. He's good. He moves it forward for 9.
Preston Johnson again with the tackle.
Uh-oh, we've got an injured DePere player. Hopefully, yeah, we don't want to see that for either team here at this point.
Hey, Jeff, that might give you just a little bit of a pause here to talk about the rest of these all-conference players. Why don't we do that here during this injury timeout on the field?
We were on swimming, girls swimming, second team diver Avery Single. In addition to swimmers Katie Olson, Riley Smith, Elise Gulick, Ellery Autumn. Honorable mention, Kaylee Volkman, diver as well, along with Gulick and Olson, who I mentioned earlier. Girls volleyball, first team, they went down to a heartbreaking defeat last Saturday night to Chippewa Falls. Happened to be at that game. One of the better high school sporting events I've been to in a long time. Tough 5-set loss to Chippewa Falls, who went on to the state tournament. First team, Brianna Brathall, Morgan Cayley. Second team, Abby Bannett and Taylor Peterson. And honorable mention, we have Becca Randleman for the Wildcats. So those are all the fall sports, all conference.
A lot of them. Congratulations to all the first team, second team, and honorable mention, all conference players for all the River Falls fall sports, boys and girls. Congratulations, and well deserved through all your hard work. Perseverance, good grades in school, being a good person, staying out of trouble, will result in an all-conference selection. All right, here we go. 2nd and 1. Shovel. Pistol. Jet sweep far side. There goes Derek Gordon Jr. He's got enough for a Phantoms first down.
Welcome to A2, Benjamin Monrod.
Yeah, I think, Kevin, that's Lemorand. I think they have
Lemorand?
Yeah, I think they have 282s on their roster.
Oh, so they do.
Yeah,
they
Ben
do.
Lemorand is
Thank
the guy
you.
Who's
Thank you.
Getting some touches out there tonight.
Yeah, they do have 282s, and I have the wrong one circled. 282s. First and 10 for West Appear. They'll take the line, shoveled, shotgun formation, flanked back there by Nyjae Mitchell. Now we've got a whistle and a stoppage of play.
Delay a game, I think, is the preliminary call.
It is a delay a game on West Appear. That'll move them back 5 yards. It'll be first and 15.
Push ball back 5 yards to the 39-yard line. First and 15.
First down and 15 now for West Appear. Empty backfield, five receivers set, three here to the near side, two up top. Duke Shovel back to pass, looking. Now he's just going to tuck it and go, and he's taken down from behind. It won't be a sack as he gets back to the line of scrimmage. It'll be second and 15.
They ran that play earlier in the first half, kind of a delayed quarterback draw type play. Something that they really haven't gone to a lot this season, but they did a good job stopping at that time.
Second and 15. They're in no hurry, up 24-0. Once again, West Appear will go with an empty backfield. It'll be Duke Shovel back there alone. He's back to pass, looking down the field, crossing route, got a man, throws a dart and makes a nice pass and catch. That one is received by number 18, Bryce Smith.
19.
Joseph Reisenberg. Thank you. Reisenberg on the reception. That'll make it third and very manageable. Third and 2. Into Wildcat territory. I'm guessing four down territory here now for West Appear. Nyjae Mitchell in the backfield with Duke Shovel. Shovel to Mitchell. Mitchell taken out of the backfield. He's not going to get the first down yardage. It might give him a foot on that. It's going to be fourth and 2.
Gavin. Really nice play by Gavin Cole that time, shooting through the gap.
Fourth down and 2.
Gavin's had a really nice game. He's made a number of tackles and finds that opening and fills that gap quickly. Good for him.
Yeah, they are going to go for it here. Up 24-0.
Under center.
They're going to try to draw them off sides, and they are. Now we're going to have a timeout, River Falls. Mm-hmm. It might be a situation there. You try to draw them off and maybe going to punt the ball. I don't know. What do you got there, Nate?
Yeah, I don't know. That, you know, they were in a pretty heavy look there. I think they were probably going to go for it, but the Wildcats had Wyatt Bell back to punt. It looks like we were a little bit early getting in our punt return formation and forced to spend a timeout, which, you know, at this point in the game, we obviously don't want to do, but a huge play here for us.
So last week, West Appear defeated New Richmond 21-6. River Falls did beat New Richmond earlier this season. It was an overtime bid.
Yes.
Yeah, and I think, you know, one of the differences in that game, New Richmond was able to keep it close. They were able to move the ball through the air. They passed the ball quite a bit, and that's how they got some yardage, and we have not been able to do that tonight ourselves, which has been costly.
Big reason for that is we have not had a lot of time to throw.
That's true.
The few times we have tried to throw the ball.
They are going to punt now. So West Appear shows punt formation. They're going to get it to the up back. They're going to fake it, and they get the first down yardage on the fake punt. They're pulling out all the stops tonight, onside kicks, fake punts, and executing every one of them. No problem on execution, guys.
No.
You know, and some teams like to save some of those things, especially in a game where you're up 3 touchdowns. But what it does do is forces the opponent for next week, if they should go on to win, to prepare for all of those extra things, which takes away from the opponent preparing themselves.
Fresh set of downs after the fake punt, fourth down conversion. Shovold hands it off to Nyjae Mitchell. He's got the outside and another quick 6 or 7 yards. We'll call it 6. It'll be second and 2.
Maurice Bevin with the tackle that time for River Falls. From the secondary.
Second and five.
Second and five, they're going to call it. Not like that. Second, look at Brayden. Second and four or five. You can pick. He leaves it open, right? We don't want to tell you what it is. You can just pick. He's going to say it's second and five. Shoveled. Pistol hands it to Najee Mitchell, met by a host of blue shirts and Wildcats. That's going to be a loss of one on the play. It'll be fourth and six.
Ben Esterby and Gavin Cole in on the tackle for River Falls.
Loss of one back to the 36. Brings him a third and six.
One time? Yeah. It's cold. Let me give it a shot. Just said one. That's a cold cameraman. He's got a little bit of the shakes.
Give that guy some hot cocoa.
Third and six. Back to pass. Shoveled crossing route. Got a man. Beautiful pass and catch. That's going to be really tough to defend. They get the inside position there. Landon Norgard on the reception there. Just a great route. Great pass.
Big receiver, too. Landon Norgard, 6'4", wide receiver.
Yeah, Norgard's dad was a great basketball player for UWGB Phoenix and played professionally for like 12, 13 years. A lot of time in Europe. Was a draft pick of the Bucks, I believe. Second rounder. Heck of a player.
First and 10 now for West Dupere again. Give it to Najee Mitchell. He's slicing. He's dicing. He's multiplying. He's dividing. He's in the end zone for six more. Four. West Dupere. The kid is good. The kid's a fast runner. The kid's tougher than a $2 steak. He's good.
He's good.
Bless you.
Probably a good time to give a shout-out to the West Dupere offensive line. They're doing a really good job opening holes for Mitchell and for protecting Schovald when he has gone back to pass. Big, tough, strong offensive line.
Kick is up and it is through, and then they have themselves a kicker as well. So with 4:51 to go here in quarter number three, it's 31-0 West Dupere all over the Wildcats tonight.
Didn't expect to say this, Kevin, but no. I think we're getting close to running clock territory, actually.
It's been such a great season for the Wildcats. They go 10-1. They've had, domination on so many games, and tonight I'm just going to say it, they're being outplayed by West Dupere.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. They're definitely
the, is that the understatement of the night?
Both sides of the field, offense and defense, and for some turnovers they capitalized on them. They're stronger, they're faster, they're a very good football team, there's no doubt.
Yeah, I would say West Dupere, with four teams left in the state, are we going to see them in the state championship game? I would almost think so. I mean, maybe run into Kaukauna, I don't know, but this is a pretty good football team, guys.
Yeah, well, they're good.
Yeah, Kaukauna, they've already played this season. West Dupere won in overtime 43-42. So you potentially could see a rematch of that game.
Well, I know West Dupere was disappointed to get a 3 seed going into the playoffs with a 1-loss record, and their only loss coming to Bayport, which was a highly ranked Division I football team as well. So they are
fielded on the 8, 40, 50. It's a foot race to the end zone. Look at the kid go. Jacob Gilbertson to the house.
No flags.
No flags. 90. With 93 yards, Jacob Gilbertson on the return. Boy, the kid turned on the afterburners, and what a return for Gilbertson.
Good for him. Good for him. He had a really nice return the last time, too, almost broke it. Yep. Good for him.
We'll go back and take a look at that again, and we get a minute here.
Looks like the Wildcats are going to go for two.
They're going to go for two. So after the two-point conversion, we'll go back and take a look at that 93-yard return soon.
Second
going for two. Jacob Range, Severson headed towards pay dirt. Won't get there. It will stick on the sixth spot.
Yeah, that double tight end formation. They just, they've got 10 guys right up against the line of scrimmage, one wide receiver set. Tough to get through there.
Let's take a look at that again, guys. Watch this beautiful return from the sidelines. Nice job there. Then it's just off to the races. 30, 20, 15, 10, 5. Gilbertson in. Breaks the tape at the goal line. I like that.
He can fly. Jacob Gilbertson, the senior.
Nice job switching on that, Braden. Get the ground level and go up to the top, upstairs. Rob Derry on the zoom. Watch him break the tape at the goal line.
The kid's good.
Yeah, not bad. It's 31-6 with 4:39 to go. A little ray of sunshine there from Gilbertson.
Well, do we suspect an onside kick here? Or are we just going to kick it away and play defense?
Well, I think West appears clearly by the way they're lined up. They're expecting that. They have seven players within, well, 15, 18 yards of the ball.
Hey, you dating match spammers, give it up. You're not going to get it. Not going to get through me. I'm telling you right now.
Kicking off blood at number 23, Mike McConway. Back to receive. To the Panthers, number 23. Thomas Walder, number 82. Benjamin Leroux.
4:39 to go in quarter number three. 31-6, West Appear. Kevin Westhouse, Jeff Johnson, Nate Sherman, the artist Rob Derry, and Braden Engstrom. And John Fry down fieldside with the camera tonight, bringing you all the action. Nope. Onside doesn't work. They don't get it.
Got a decent bounce, but
yeah.
A good aggressive recovery by number 80. That's Judea Criskern.
At the
47-yard line. First down. And the Wildcat defense is back out in the field. They've been out there a lot tonight, Nate.
Yes, they have.
Back the pass. Crossing route. Just a little bit too tall for Ryder LeSage.
Really good coverage that time by Wyatt Bell, who was right with LeSage. No surprise they're throwing the ball here.
Yeah, I was a little surprised as well, but take a shot. And the way they've been running the ball, I'm sure they're relatively confident here that with a couple downs they can manage.
Second and 10. Shoveled. Fake play action, rolls out to his right, throw it on the field, got a man. Ryder LeSage pushed out of bounds, but not until after he gained 17 more yards for West Appear.
You know, again, you just can't say enough about the play design. They flood that zone on the bottom half of your screen. One guy goes deep, the first guy is in the flat near the linebacker and then drifts back 10 yards behind. The rollout with the pass right over the top. Well done.
Well executed. Clock stopped as he's pushed out of bounds. Ball's now on the 34-yard line of the River Falls Wildcats. West Appear knocking on the door again. Handed off to Mitchell. Pounds it up in there for two.
Looked like Kaminsky and Yonke in on the tackle.
Second down and eight now for West Appear. They'll take the line. Landon Norgaard is put way out to the far side. They have two receivers out there. Schovolt's going to hand it off to Mitchell. Bounces it to the outside. Real nice tackle, though, by Johnson. Preston Johnson, the sophomore, steps up, wraps up, and drives down to planet Earth. Nice tackle by the sophomore, Preston Johnson.
Yeah, and I saw Gavin Cole really get in there early, too. Great job by both those guys.
Sophomore was racking up some tackles tonight.
Not always a good sign, Kevin, when he is.
We talked about that earlier, right?
Proud of him, obviously, but that's...
Dad would prefer more pass deflections than tackles, right?
Third
down. I prefer he was on the bench more, actually.
Third and eight. Cross route. That's behind the intended receiver and falls incomplete. That was intended for Landon Norgard. Falls incomplete just behind him. Fourth down and eight.
Yeah, and that slant is so effective, especially when you run the ball well. The linebacker's initial step is forward. They can't get the depth to disrupt that pass, and had it been on target, it probably would have been a first down.
Fourth down and eight. They're going to go for it. West Appear, Duke Shovel, empty backfield. Three receivers here to the near side, two up top. It's backyard football for West Appear. Shovel receives the rock. He's back to pass. Eyes downfield. Now he's going to step up in the pocket, and he's in trouble. Caden Mischewski, the muscle, with a big sack there. They'll turn it over on downs.
We do have a flag on the play.
Flag on the play. What do we have?
Well,
they're all facing...
Looks like they're lining up for a race there,
doesn't it? Yeah, it does. Let's see. Is it after the play? That's going to be declined. That was a false start or legal motion. Legal motion on West Appear. That's declined, and River Falls will take over on downs. They hold on fourth down.
So that's an official sack then. So that means Black Wolf Exteriors, right? And Joe Karras.
Yeah, Joe Karras. $50 more to the Sunshine Fund.
From the bingo card.
Put another kernel of corn on our bingo card. Moves it forward for two, does Jonas Severson.
Jonas Severson with carry. Stop number six, Carter Smith.
Second down and eight now for River Falls. It's a crisp night. I don't know what the temperature is. 38, 39? What do you think?
Yeah.
Something like that. It's crisp. Heat's on in here with the window open. It's not bad. I got a sweater on. I haven't even gone to the coat yet. Second and eight. Hand it to Severson again, and he's met in the backfield.
Stop 31, Jacob Breyer.
Jacob Breyer on the tackle. He was unblocked, and he met him right in the backfield. 37 degrees. It felt about like 38, but I was close.
Close. If you pick the over, you were good.
Right. Well, we're glad you folks at home are enjoying the game again. We're here to celebrate the kids, and we're going to keep you on the edge of your couch and have a good time for a couple hours, escape all the realities of life going on around us, and just enjoy some good high school football. That's the goal. Severson again. Pounds it up in there. Look at him work hard. He's moving forward towards first down yardage. He's going to be 2 yards short. It'll be fourth and two, and I think you got to go for it here, don't you?
Yep, absolutely. Given the score, given how much time's left. Won't be easy, though. 2 yards have been pretty tough to come by against this West Appear defense.
Fourth down and two. Yeah. They've been stingy.
Double tight end set still. And
here to the near side. They'll probably run right behind them there. They're trying to draw them off sides. Yeah, they'll run probably right here to the left side, I'm guessing. Yes, they do. We've seen that play a few times, and they got it for first down yardage. Ran that play all year, double tight end set. You get the muscle kid, Mischewski, blowing a little extra hole.
Run behind him
and gain 4 or 5.
Yeah, and they had 10 defenders in the box there. Single coverage on the bottom of your screen with Karras. And probably time to take a shot or two.
Got to here. First and 10, first set of downs. That play right there you just witnessed, that's been money all season. First and 10. Nice job again by Severson. Pounds it forward for four more. It'll be second and six.
Jordan Severson on carry. Stop number 31, Jacob Breyer.
See if they get one more playoff, Kevin, before the end of the third quarter here.
27 seconds. You'd think he would probably try to do that. Get as many plays in as you can. Advance the rock. It just is over the 50-yard line now. They're into West DePere territory. Single receiver up top. Play action. Looking down the field, and he's in big trouble. Range escapes, and now he's getting swarmed down in the backfield. That is a tough sack there. Slung down for a loss of 10 on the play. There was nowhere to go there.
Takes it into the third quarter of the score. West DePere, 31, River Falls, 6.
Three quarters of play in the books. It is West DePere, 31, River Falls, 6. Let's go thank our sponsor, First National Bank of River Falls.
First National Bank of River Falls is a proud sponsor of River Falls High School. We've been sponsoring River Falls High School athletics for over 50 years. We're proud to support area students, student athletes, and educators within our schools. Together, we are building a better community, one child at a time.
Thank you, First National Bank of River Falls. They're over there in Prescott. They're in downtown River Falls, and they're on the campus of the University of Wisconsin, River Falls. Get on there and check out their interest rates. They'll help you with a home loan, a car loan, a snowmobile loan, maybe open a savings account. How about that? Nothing wrong with that either. Savings account rates are higher. That's some good news.
We're getting there.
You know, after that last sack there, Jacob Range came out a little hobbled. So senior Dylan Brathall in the game at quarterback at the moment.
Dylan Brathall, the senior, in at quarterback for River Falls now.
Pretty tough position for him to be in coming into the game cold on a 4th and 17.
Third and 17.
Scoreboard says 4.
Delayed handoff. Severson runs it up, though, for about, gets about 10 of those yards back. It'll be now 4th and 3. 4th and 4, we call it. 4th and 4. Nice hard run there by Severson. Still running hard.
You know, maybe an opportunity here to talk a little bit about Dylan Brathall, the starting quarterback at the beginning of the year, who lost his position to Jacob Range, who really has come on as of late and throughout the course of the season. And there's a great picture last week of Dylan greeting his teammate Jacob coming off the field. Just big smile, big hug, high fives, just being a really good teammate as a senior.
It's awesome. Back to pass, looking. Rainbow down the near side. Karras up and won't make the catch. And there's a flag on the play. Little hand jive in there. Little hand, what do you call it? You know, hand check, hand jiving.
Hand fighting, hand-to-hand combat.
They're going to throw the flag, pass interference.
Pretty nice throw by Dylan. Coming in, like I said, coming into the game cold. And
yeah, nice
got
throw.
Got it in the area, gave him a chance, which is all you can ask for.
Yeah, it almost looked like Jordan misread the ball a little bit, stopped, and then had to adjust late, and probably was the cause of the penalty.
We'll take a look at that again. Nice job by the senior. Great rainbow. Karras, a little ticky-tack,
I thought, too.
Yeah.
Thomas Walder, he wouldn't agree with it.
We'll take it.
Take it. Again, rainbow down the far side looking for Karras. Caught but out of bounds.
Good coverage.
Real good coverage. Nice job with that body to force Karras out, you know.
And a good ball. You know, throws it in a spot where only his receiver can get it. And throws that ball in play. It's probably an interception.
Second down and 10. Wildcats on into West DePere territory. Knowles of the ball rests on the 32. Brathall hands it off to Severson. It's a tough 2 yards there for Severson. It'll be 3rd and 8.
Jordan Severson, 7 and 9. Isaac Casper. Third and 8, Wildcats. At the West of here.
Jacob's still walking with a pretty good limp on the bench there. I've been keeping an eye on him. Not sure he'll be back in. We'll see.
A little hitch in the giddy up, they say. 3rd and 8. Brathall under center. Back the pass, rolling out. Got a man in the flat. That's Mischewski. Pushes the ball forward. He's going to be just short of first down yardage. He gets it close to first down yardage. It's about a yard and a half short. It'll be fourth and two. That's been a pretty effective play this year as well. That little throw to Mischewski in the flat and let the muscle do his work and run guys over.
Good job by Dillon throwing on the run there a little bit too, kind of getting out of the pocket and avoiding the pass rush and threw a nice ball to Cade.
Fourth down and two. Mischewski and Severson in the backfield, single receiver up top. Rolling out. Got a man going for the end zone. Oh, just overthrown. That was intended for Eli Johnson, I believe, just out of the outstretched arms. And he had him down there. Just,
he did.
Just missed him.
It was the right read. Just didn't quite put it on him.
Here's the ball over on downs. First down. West of here.
Wildcats will turn it over on downs. They needed that one there. You don't want to second guess Brathall. He probably could have ran that there, but he saw he had a guy and just missed him.
No, I think it was the right, like you said, it was the right read.
And yep.
He had Eli open near the end zone and just a little bit off.
Yeah. So West DePere will take over on the 24-yard line. Mitchell cuts it up. We're still running hard. And another tackle by Preston Johnson, the sophomore. It's about half a dozen for him tonight. I would say that's his season high, I guess.
He's had a lot, that's for sure. Big shout-out to Sean Johnson, along with the Richardsons and the Schmidts at the lake. Welcome to my brother and the Richardsons and Schmidts at the lake.
Love it.
Oh, appreciate you watching.
Good spot to be watching a football game on a crisp fall Friday night. Level 3 WIAA action. Slips down, gains his footing. Mitchell spins, someone hits the control B button. He's still moving forward and gains 7 yards out of nothing.
Really good vision, lateral quickness, good balance there. He slipped initially on his first cut, got his hand down to prop himself up and made a nice gain out of it.
Yeah, he's athletic. Nigel Mitchell, he's a 5'10", 181-pound senior. Handed off again. Still pounding it up in there. Several Wildcats in on the tackle. Preston Johnson in there. And he's up.
Yeah, Mitchell and Jordan Karras will be teammates next year at UMD. Karras going to UMD, and if I understand that right, I think they were hoping that he would play defensive back.
Mitchell?
No, Karras.
Karras.
And I think I could have swore I saw that Mitchell was maybe slotted to be a receiver at Duluth, but I could be wrong about both of those.
Mitchell again carries it up in there, gain of a couple. So we haven't talked much about the Garage Gridiron Grinder Award. Gary Langer said if you're going to start a list, he said I'd put number 10 on that list, and Preston Johnson with all his tackles. List is not really, whiteboard's pretty blank tonight.
Yes.
It's okay, though. Crossing route, caught. Nice 5 yards there. Once again, that goes to their horse, Ryder LeSage, I believe.
Good show off pass. Pick number 10, Ryder LeSage.
Yep. They got a pretty good chemistry going, don't they?
Yeah, I like how they use the pass, kind of like the run at times. Mm-hmm. You know, just a short, quick route snap, one step, and let it rip right over the middle, right in the gap between the linebackers. Taking advantage of the opportunities that are given to them, not taking a big shot every time, but working those middle of the field openings.
Third down and 5 now for West DePere. Back to pass. Shovel, a little
little inside screen.
Inside screen again, and that goes to Landon Norgaard. And they've run that a couple times tonight, Nate, and it's been effective the times they've run it.
Yep, wide receiver screen. They've run some screens to Najee Mitchell, and I would say that's about the fifth screen pass they've run tonight.
At least, and they've all been, other than stopping one time, I think, they've been very, very effective.
Yeah, I think the one time he just had to throw it over Cade Bishefsky's hands and was a little bit high for the receiver. Other than that, big gainers.
First and 10 now for West DePere. 6:50 to go in the contest. Nigel Mitchell again, forward for 8. All night long. I don't have his total stats, but he's got to be around a 125?
I would say so, yeah. At least that. He's had a lot of carries. They've 24-yard line. Second. They've kept him from making the long 30 to 40-yard run, but he's got a lot of 7, 8, 9-yard runs tonight.
Yeah, he's death by a 1,000 paper cuts, right?
Second down, and we'll call it 2. Mitchell again to the outside. Missed tackle. Still going. Now a nice swarm down. Oh, baby. Nice job there by Jacob Gilbertson. He came to play in the second half, didn't he?
Yep, he did. That was a good team tackle right there. They kept him bottled up and wouldn't let him hit the corner, and good job by the Wildcat defense there.
Yeah, that exact play is where he really hurt New Richmond, where he starts up the middle, jump cuts, and breaks it around the corner. So good discipline by the Wildcat defense on that play.
Stringing that out, and Gilbertson just on mop-up duty, driving him into the bench area. Third down and 8. Back to pass. Shoveled. In a bit of trouble. Mishefsky in pursuit, and you have to just throw it away.
I think that was maybe another screen set up there,
yes,
Jeff.
Yes, that's what they're trying to do for sure. It's been effective.
I like how they get the motion going away from the screen. They have the quarterback look that way early, pivot opposite.
That was Alec Ross on the pursuit there, not Cade Mishefsky. Okay. I apologize. That 5 was a little scrunched up, kind of looked like a 6, but nice job by Alec Ross in pursuit there.
Well, 4th and 8 from the 29. Looks like they're going to go for it again.
Todd Rokamp said he'd like to vote for Gilbertson for the grinder. Back to pass is Schovold, looking down the field, still looking. There's nobody open. Now he's going to scramble, and now this guy does get free. Caught on the far side again by Ryder Lesage. And he's a little dinged up down there near the 10-yard line.
Really nice job again by the wide receiver reading the play. The play breaks apart, and instead of just standing put, he finds the opening, and quarterback finds him.
He had a ton of time to throw that time, Nate. It's really tough for a secondary to cover that long as well. And Lesage is their guy. There's no doubt about that. That's typically who he looks for first, and he's had a big game tonight.
You bet.
First and 10 now. Nose of the ball rests on the 12-yard line. West DePere looking to put some more points on the board here late in the game. A little exclamation mark on this thing for them. Najee Mitchell falls forward. Boy, even on a play that doesn't look like it's going anywhere, they get 5 or 6.
Give up 5 to the 6-yard line. Brings up 2nd and 5 for the Panthers.
Yeah, Mitchell's elusive. You know, I would imagine there's a handful of times the linemen are staring him right in the eyes thinking, I got him, and come up after grasping and getting only air.
Mitchell headed towards pay dirt. Won't quite get there. Down to the 2.
Najee Mitchell wrapped up at number 29. Gavin Cole
with the tackle. Wildcat defense still playing hard. They have been out on the field a long time.
Yeah, they have.
Yeah.
Gavin Cole in there again.
Nice job, Gavin Cole, on stuffing that at the line. It'll be probably fourth and goal, and maybe a measurement here. It's going to be really close, guys.
They can actually get the first down.
They can without
scoring here.
So I said, really, Mark, the ball is going to be really close to first down yardage. Are they going to measure that?
Nope.
Said fourth down. So fourth and half a yard. Fourth and half a yard. And now there's a whistle and a stoppage of play. And we have timeout. West Appear. What do you think for GG right here?
Yeah, he's on the list for sure.
Who is?
I was going to maybe stay away from that, but I think in this situation, the kids will be adjusted enough, I believe. Yeah. I mean, he's had one hell of a game.
But he's got two more years of chances for that.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. I mean, I agree.
Yeah, and that player hasn't won it yet, yeah. Right?
Yeah. So I think.
No, yeah. You're correct.
Yeah. And we get a lot of people online suggesting that as well. So.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How you doing, John Fry? We're getting some good shots. Hey, on that touchdown return, we had your shot on for up to the 50-yard line. There we go, fourth down. Up the middle, give it to the fullback, and I think he's in. Touchdown, West Appear.
Number eight.
We haven't called this name, Joseph Joyner.
Called him on defense a few times. He's made some tackles.
Fullback position is give it to the fullback, and they John Cooned that right in there. Quick run. Quick hitter. That'll put a 37 spot up for West Appear.
I think that was Ethan Collar, two number eights as well.
Oh, okay. There you go. There is. Oh, yep.
Is that who it was?
Ethan Collar. Right. Yep, there's two eights on the sheet. I picked the wrong one. I had a 50-50 chance twice, and I was
you're
wrong both
times.
I'm 0 for
2.
38-6 after the completed extra point with 3:02 to go in the game. And we're going to do the Grinder Trophy, so after this, you want to come down with me? Okay. All right, I will. Six with 3:02 to go. It was 3:02 to go, but I think Jacob Gilbertson, the senior tonight, he had a nice 94-yard kickoff return, in on a lot of tackles. The
couple senior, pass deflections.
Yep, the seniors just had one heck of a season. I think he's going to be our Garage Gridiron Grinder recipient tonight, if you guys are okay with that.
Yep, absolutely.
Yeah, you bet.
Jacob will have one more chance here to perhaps run with the ball. And he does.
Gilbertson's got it back at the 10, the 15. Cuts it back. Still working hard out to the 26-yard line. Jacob Gilbertson, great effort tonight. Second half of football, he came out to play. And a good effort by
Jacob
the senior.
Gilbertson with the return takes up the 26-yard line. First down.
Well, West Appear will head to the state semifinals next week, where they will face either Kaukauna or Homestead.
Kaukauna still leading that game?
13-6 at halftime. They got off to a late start.
Oh, that's right. The lightning, the November lightning storm.
Yes. Actually, an update on that game. Kaukauna now leads 20-6.
Okay.
They scored on their first drive of the second half.
Give it to Severson. Hucks it up in there. Tell you what, I'm going to try to go down and beat the crowd. I think myself and John will go down. I'll get ready to
present the Grinder Trophy to Jacob Giberson, and we can enter, pack ourselves up. But before I go down there, in case I don't get back up in time, what a fun season it's been, guys.
It really has.
I mean,
a lot of memories that I'm sure once they have a chance to reflect a little bit on the season, and the sting of this loss goes away, it's a lot of fond memories that they're going to have for the rest of their lives, Kevin.
It's a record-type season here in River Falls. Second time ever to this level. Mm. And that's knocked down, almost intercepted out there. And it'll be third down. No, it's one for the record books, one for the memory bank that's going to be tough to replicate. So,
yeah, by a team that really not this much was expected out of at the beginning of the year. They thought they'd be contenders for a conference title, but I don't think there's too many people that predicted they'd go 10-2 and advance to level 3 in the playoffs.
Right. Sure. It's been a very exciting season. Hey, it's been really fun hanging out with you guys, too. I've looked forward to this every week. We talk about it. You know, work's tough and whatnot, but just this is really a nice couple hours to spend with you guys. Enjoy the heck out of it every single week. Thanks for all you do in volunteering, coming up here and getting this done.
It's a lot of fun. Thanks for all you do, Kevin. I mean, you're the one that puts this whole thing together, and it's a passion for you, I know. It has been for many years. It was an idea that was like 5-6 years ago that you had, and it's really taken off, and it's
fun.
It's
and
a
we
lot
hope,
of fun.
And we hope the folks at home enjoy it as much as we do, and that's the objective, so grandma and grandpa and aunts and uncles and can enjoy the games. So that's our objective, and hopefully that's happening. So I'm going to go down field side, and I'll find Jacob Gilbertson, and we'll present the award, and keep it short. How about that?
Perfect.
All
sounds
right.
good.
See ya. And don't forget to pull up the garage logo this time, please. Thank you.
Do you have the trophy? Well, first down there. Looks like on a fourth down play to Jonas Severson. Clock at 1:28 left here in the fourth quarter. West Appear leads at 38-6. Dylan Brathall, the senior, still in at quarterback. Rolls out that time. Fumbles, ball's loose, still loose. And it's finally recovered by number 53. That's Nathan Held. We've called his name. Called his name a few times tonight.
Yeah, just a little bit of a slow developing play there with heavy pressure from the defensive line. And Dylan trying to make a play, trying to evade a tackler and get a throw off, and they poked the ball out. And I would suspect at this point that DePere will just get in the victory formation and take a knee. Up 38-6 with 59 ticks of the clock remaining.
That's how it appears. Showball takes one knee. We'll have to take one more, and that'll do it.
Yeah, I suspect we'll spend the final time here on air talking about the Wildcats, but before we do that, I'd like to wish West Appear Phantoms luck the rest of the way. They have a really, really good football team, well-coached, disciplined players, fast and strong and skilled, and I'm expecting big things from them here the remainder of the season. So good luck to the Phantoms.
Yeah, very, very possible they'll end up facing Kaukauna again for the second time this season.
And potentially Sun Prairie in the state championship game, right?
Well, actually, Kettle Moraine leads Sun Prairie right now 21-6 in the fourth quarter.
Okay.
And that will do it here for the 2022 River Falls Wildcats season. They fall to West Appear by a score of 38-6. Wildcats finish the year 10-2. Co-champions of the Big Rivers Conference, so an awful lot to be proud of. Right?
Yeah, you know, high hopes, obviously, for the players and the fans and the coaches coming into this game, and not the way that they wanted the season to come to an end, but it was clear pretty early that we were a little bit outmatched tonight, and you can't fault the effort or the preparation. It just sometimes the ball doesn't bounce your way. We had a couple chances early. We had a couple turnovers early that they capitalized on when we didn't. And you know, who knows? We punch one in early in the game, and maybe with a little confidence, things would have been slightly different. But I think we can say that the better team won today.
Oh, there's no doubt about that. River Falls just had a hard time getting the run game going. Certainly, whenever they did try to pass, Jacob Range was really, really struggling, trying to find time to throw the ball. And defensively, I think they just kind of wore him down. The Wildcat defense was on the field for about, you know, close to two-thirds of the game. And pretty tough to win that one.
Yeah, not something that the Wildcat defense is used to. I mean, the way that we've controlled the ball, the Wildcats have controlled the ball offensively during the course of the year. And we've talked about how our offense oftentimes was our best defense. You know, our defense was rested. The other team's defense would have to, you know, be on the field a lot. And tonight it was the opposite.
Looks like teams are switching sides to celebrate here, and some pretty good sportsmanship.
Yeah, nice of the Phantoms. Right, yeah, it's just that's the typical end that the Wildcats go to after a game, and they move themselves down to the opposite side. Appreciate that.
Great group of seniors, Nate, that the Wildcats had this season that played some really solid football. A lot of all-conference candidates, which we outlined earlier, and that group is going to be missed.
Yeah, it's always hard as a senior playing your last game in any sport, and as dads, we've been through that, whether as athletes ourselves or as parents of athletes, and, you know, I think the parents of these kids can be proud of the effort and the commitment the kids have made during the course of the season, and the life lessons that they've learned, and I know that the coaching staff does a lot more than teaching.
Guys, am I breaking up there, or you got me okay? All right, we're going to wait for Jacob Gilbertson after the coach gets done in the huddle, so I'll be right with you.
All right.
Jacob Gilbertson, senior, number 24, will be our culminating Garage Gridiron Grinder of the Game Award designee. Long 93-yard touchdown run, another nice kick return for about 40 yards, if I'm not mistaken, a couple pass deflections, in on some tackles, and he's had a good season for the Wildcats, and a nice way for him to finish his career with that recognition.
He really has. He's done a really nice job at the corner position, and like you said too, Nate, that serving as one of their primary kickoff returners, and good solid kid. Great athlete, and I think just an excellent winner for our last award of the season here.
Coach Scher is taking some time here to address his players, I'm sure recognizing his seniors, talking about the standard that this club has met and the expectation now that's left for upcoming classes and teams that come along in the future. You know, you talked about how the expectation for this year wasn't necessarily to win the conference, to make it to level 3 of the playoffs, to win double-digit games 10-2 on the season after losing 4 out of 5 offensive linemen, their starting quarterback, their top 2 running backs, top wide receiver, 2 middle linebackers. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. And for this group to accomplish what they did with all of those key losses from last year says a lot about the kids and the time they put into the weight room and their attention to detail, and of course the coaching staff putting in positions to be successful.
Exactly. You know, and a lot of the seniors, Nate, they hadn't played a ton of football.
Right.
You know, I think of a kid like Reese Yonke, who, you know, did such a fantastic job, leading tackler on the team, and he was a kid, you know, a senior that who's obviously played his last football game in high school tonight, who didn't even play a lot of varsity football last year. And there's some other kids like Reese too, and it's really, really cool to see when a kid's able to do that during their last season of their
career. There's a lot of kids who don't do that, right? Mm-hmm. I don't play when I'm a sophomore. I don't play when I'm a junior. They hang it up, and credit to them for sticking with it and biding their time and waiting their turn and then taking advantage of
With senior Gilbertson, Jacob, you ran into a buzzsaw tonight.
What? Saw it tonight. Yeah. It's pretty good.
Yeah, they sure were. They're pretty tough.
Yeah. Second half, they were to play. And nice return. Good blocking up front, and you were off to the races. Tell me how that felt. Just walk me through that real briefly.
I was really tired, but, yeah, it felt really good. Points upon the scoreboard for our team, so, yeah.
Pleasure this year. Yeah. Great game. Tackled, broke up a lot of passes. One heck of a game there, senior. Great job. Tonight's direct. The game. We'll let you go on. All right, son. Great season. Great game. You bet. Privilege watching you. All right, privilege watching. Let me get your picture real quick. I'm going to take this right back upstairs.
All right. Thanks, Kevin. Very, very polite Jacob Gilbertson thanking Kevin for the interview and did a good job tonight. But obviously it wasn't enough as the Wildcats fall to West Appear by a score of 38-6 here in WIAA Division II Level 3 football. The Phantoms will move on to the state semifinals next week where they'll take on either Kaukauna or Homestead at a neutral site. So I think like Kevin likes to say, I think we'll put a red bow on this, Nate, and we'll call it a season here on the River Falls Sports YouTube network. On behalf of Kevin Westhouse, Nate Sherman, Braden Engstrom, the artist, Rob Derry, I'm Jeff Johnson signing off for the 2022 season. Again, the final score, West Appear 38, River Falls 6. Good night, everybody.